Liberty Bowl football. It's the Crimson Tide of the University of Alabama versus the Fighting Illini of the University of Illinois. Live from Liberty Bowl Memorial Stadium in Memphis, Tennessee. Tonight's 1982 Liberty Bowl Football Classic is brought to you by Anheuser-Busch of St. Louis, Brewers of Michelob. Some things speak for themselves. By Federal Express, when you have a package that absolutely, positively has to be there overnight. By Holiday Inn, the only hotel that gives you a no-excuses guarantee. And by S-Mart, which brings you Swift, Playtex, Figaro, STP, Danskin, Germack, and Jensen. Hi, everybody. Metro Sports welcomes you to the 24th annual Liberty Bowl. I'm Harry Callis, along with the Pac-10 Coach of the Year, University of California's Joe Capp. And the entire nation is focused on Memphis, Tennessee tonight, Joe. It appears that a man has superseded the event.
Well, there's no question that Coach Bryant is a legend in his own time, and I think that that's a big part of this football game will be the tremendous emotion that's involved with when a great man like this retires from the game of football. I think that both teams have those great, potent offenses, the great passing attack of the University of Illinois, the great wishbone offense that Alabama uses, and the key to the game will how will both teams deal with the emotion of it and how to stop each other's high-powered offense.
Take a closer look at Illinois and Alabama. Let's go down to our expert on the field, Johnny Holliday. Johnny?
Harry, the last time Illinois played in a bowl game was January 1st of 1964. But the Fighting Illini are ready for the spotlights tonight. Coach Mike White has developed an explosive offense that ranks fourth in the country. That attack is triggered by Champagne Tony Eason, a strong arm slinger. He holds 9 NCAA passing records. If Illinois is to win tonight over Alabama, Tony Eason is the man. And inside the Alabama locker room, the Crimson Tide getting set to go on the football field for the last time under head coach Paul Bear Bryant. The Bear makes his 24th straight bowl appearance tonight. The traditional wishbone grinds out over 400 yards a game. Deceptive quarterback Walter Lewis is the team's second leading rusher. But Alabama can also throw the football on you with success. All in all, it's a typical Alabama football team.
We'll be back with the 24th annual Liberty Bowl right after this.
See where Alabama has won the toss. It's 32 degrees, wind chill factor of 25. The field is dry and fast, and the winds will not be a particular factor tonight. The first meeting between the two teams, Alabama and Illinois. For the Crimson Tide, their 24th consecutive bowl appearance. Meanwhile, Illinois has not been bowling for quite some time, since 1964, but Mike White has really turned this program around for the Fighting Illini. The deep men for Alabama will be Joey Jones, number 4, Craig Turner, number 44, and Paul Carruth, number 16. Doing the kicking for Illinois, Joey Jones is the man in the middle, and Mike Bass comes down on the ball, and the 24th annual Liberty Bowl underway. A squib kick picked up by a short man at the 20, and Alabama has it at the 30-yard line. Picking up the ball for Alabama, number 26, that was Ricky Moore. Offensively for Alabama, Walter Lewis, their quarterback, a junior. Paul Carruth is a one halfback. The other halfback is Jeff Fagan. And their leading rusher at fullback is Ricky Moore. He's a big one at 235. Joey Jones, big play wide receiver. Jesse Bendris is the other wide receiver. First and 10, Alabama from the wishbone. Hand off to the halfback. Big hole up to the 37-yard line goes Jeff Fagan, the senior from Hollywood, Florida. A pickup of 7 on the play. No huddle for Alabama, Joe Cal.
Illinois is in a 4-3 defense. They feature a 4-deep secondary.
Lewis going to pass on second down. Incomplete. It was intended for Jesse Vendress. Offensive line for Alabama. Joe Beasley, 250 pounds. Mike Adcock is the left guard. Steve Mott, co-captain and center. Willard Sism is one of the guards, a right guard. Bob Kayevec, the tackle. On a third down and three, Alabama. Lewis, inside handoff, first down. Fagan carries the ball. Average 3.4 per carry, and he has picked up an Alabama first down, and Alabama again lining up quickly without a huddle.
Once again, trying to keep Illinois off balance with their no-huddle offense. Both split ends, wishbone.
First and 10, Alabama. They have it at their own 43-yard line. Lewis on the option, pitches back, juggled, but recovered in time for a first down for Alabama. Paul Carruth, the ball carrier, shake it up.
You see the wishbone offense here now. The field is fast. It's regular grass. Just the way the coach drew it up.
Carruth was shaken up on the play after picking up a first down. Lenny Patrick is coming to take his place, a junior from Jasper, Alabama. First and 10, Alabama. They have the ball at the Illinois 45-yard line.
The field is fast, Harry, and the weather here is crisp. It's cold, but it's crisp and dry. And I think it's not going to hurt either ball team, the weather.
Paul Carruth, 6'1", 210-pound junior out of Summit, Mississippi, being helped off the field. I'm sure he'll be back. He's a tough customer. Jones wide to the left, Vendress wide to the right on a first and 10, Alabama at the Illinois 45-yard line. Walter Lewis calling signals. Hand off goes to Jeff Fagan. Fagan picked up about 2 yards before he is stacked up by the Illinois front.
Illinois has not faced a wishbone offense for several years, and they're going to get good practice at it here.
35 bowl games for the Crimson Tide. That's an NCAA mark. It's second down and 7. The action. Lenny Patrick juggled momentarily. Fumble. Illinois recovers. Lenny Patrick juggled, then he fumbled, and Illinois has pounced on the football. So the first turnover of the game, Joe Cap.
That's one of the problems with the wishbone. Alabama has lost 23 fumbles on the season. The running back did not get the ball in time to put it away. Some heavy, hard-hitting defensive tackling. The ball comes loose.
Big hit by Clint Haynes, forcing the fumble, and Illinois will have the ball for the first time tonight. First and 10, Illini. They have it at their 42-yard line.
And they are not going with a huddle. They are going to call their plays at the line of scrimmage, and they're going with a double tight end offense.
Tony Eason, the brilliant quarterback, back to throw for Illinois. He fires a sideline. It's caught, and he paid. It was caught by Oliver Williams, and he was really rocked down hard. Tony Eason, Heisman candidate, the quarterback. Joe Curtis will be one of the running backs, along with Mike Murphy at fullback. Tim Brewster, the tight end. Their wideouts are excellent. Mike Martin, 69 catches this year to lead the nation, and Oliver Williams at the other wideout. Eason calling signals. On a draw play, not much there. Pickup of a couple of yards on the play, brought down by Scott McCray.
Illinois will use the draw a lot today.
Jim Jeriga will be a one tackle. Rick Schulte will be at a guard. Adam Lingner at center. Mark Kelly also a center being switched to guard. Bob Stowe will be at the other tackle. For the Fighting Illini, they have a third down and about 5 call as Tony Eason barks the signal. Senior from Walnut Grove, California. Flags down the play. Alabama jumped. They were drawn off by Illinois. It'll be a procedure penalty against Illinois, it appears.
Alabama uses a more conventional college defense, 3-4-4. They will flip-flop their strong side linebacker and weak side linebacker.
Illinois fourth in the nation in passing. Oh, the penalty is against Alabama. Evidently, Illinois was not guilty of illegal procedure. Alabama jumped. So Illinois now will have third and very short.
It's the defense. It's third down.
The officials are from the Great Independence from the East. Third down and very short. Eason tries to sneak it. Right there was nose guard Mike Rodriguez. I don't know. He didn't have much to get, but I don't know if he got it at all. Eason trying to sneak. And the officials will call a timeout for the measure.
Okay. It's going to be a TV timeout.
Trying to go right over center Mark Kelly from Edwardsville, Illinois, the senior, 255 pounds. First down, Illinois. Well, the Illini have it in Alabama territory at the Crimson Tide 48-yard line, where it'll be first and 10 for Illinois. Jam-packed stadium, Liberty Bowl, Memorial Stadium. Alabama was driving with the ball on their first possession. They fumbled. Illinois recovering, and the Illini have picked up a first down. And with the score, Illinois nothing, Alabama nothing. We'll be back after this.
I tell you, the atmosphere behind the Illinois bench is just as exciting as it is across the field on the Alabama side. These guys realize they're going to have a football game in their hands. I know Alabama feels that way. Illinois with the ball and driving.
All right, Johnny and Tony, Eason, first and 10 for Illinois at the Alabama 48-yard line. Illinois a little mixed up in the alignment. Now they switch to the eye, and Eason's going to throw just a little flat pass. Complete. He's got his man close to a first down. Goes Dwight Beverly. Dwight Beverly, the junior from Long Beach, California.
This is a quick screen pass to the right. Lineman out in front of this play. Alabama did not come up and force it inside. They hung back. The secondary hung back.
Tommy Wilcox, the tackle for Alabama. It's first and 10, Illinois, a pickup of 11. That's how many yards Illinois averages through the air, 295 per game. Tony Eason, the quarterback, on first and 10. Eason again back to throw. Fires the sideline, got his man. Inside the Alabama 20 goes Mike Martin.
Alabama's going to see a lot of this all afternoon. Mike Martin, leading receiver in the country. Down and out. Excellent protection. Tony Eason shows the big arm that he has. Caught it in the seam of the zone.
Mike Martin caught 69 catches during the regular season, more than any other receiver in the country. Averaged 6.3 catches per game. Second in the nation in that department. First and 10, Illinois. They have it at the Alabama 19-yard line. Inside handoff on a draw play.
Illinois will use the run, Harry, just basically to keep the defense off balance, keep those defensive linemen at home, because they're going to pass the football.
Broadcast cablecast rights this game are granted by the Liberty Bowl Committee to Metro Communications Incorporated. Any rebroadcast or other use of this telecast without written consent is prohibited. The announcers on this telecast have been paid and are paid by Metro Communications Incorporated in consultation with the Liberty Bowl Committee. A pickup on the play by Rooks of 2 yards. It'll be second down and 8. Eason wants to throw for it. Rolling out. Gets his pass away. It is in and out of the grasp of the intended receiver, tight end Tim Brewster.
Alabama playing a two-deep defense down inside the 20. Most teams will go into a man-to-man coverage down here. They completely left Eason free to run. Eason chose to drop it in with no success.
So it is a third down and 8 call for Tony Eason.
Eason couldn't have run the ball for a big game, but that's not their game. That's not the Illini's way to go.
Eason likes to throw, third in the nation in total offense this year. Third down and eight. Alabama showing blitz. Eason looking, fires in the corner, and is batted away on a fine defensive play.
A great play by
Stan Gay, number 28.
He laid off the receiver just the right amount and came up and made the big play. Here's the replay. Alabama man-to-man on that one. It's a dangerous maneuver sometimes to step in front.
Oliver Williams, the intended receiver. Fine defensive play by Stan Gay, the senior from Tuskegee, Alabama. And now the outstanding Illinois place kicker, Mike Bass, will attempt the conversion. Tim Damron will hold. This will be her attempt, the field goal. This will be a 35-yard attempt, and it's blocked by Alabama. Alabama will take over as the field goal is blocked. It was blocked by Randy Edwards.
And Harry, I think that's the kind of game this is going to be. We've seen a block punt, we've seen a fumble.
Randy Edwards getting the big pause in for Alabama. The Crimson Tide will take over on the blocked field goal try. First and 10, Alabama. They'll have it at their 24-yard line. Nothing, nothing. 10:21 left to play here in the first quarter. From the wishbone, Walter Lewis brings out the Crimson Tide. Lewis, play action, has a lot of time, going deep, and it is caught for a first down at the Illinois 26-yard line, Joey Jones.
A beautiful pass, great fake. The wishbone offense, tremendous ability to fake. Lewis gets the ball upfield. A little bit of a Cadillac fin on the back of it.
So Alabama, who's known as a ground team, completing a 50-yard strike from Walter Lewis to Joey Jones. First and 10, Alabama. They have it at the 26-yard line. Lewis going to throw again up the middle, caught inside the 10 for a first down by Jesse Bendris.
The wishbone attack with the tremendous ability to run and make yards on the ground, opens up play pass, as you see here. Lewis drops back, finds his receiver, the seam of the defense, fine completion.
First and goal, Alabama. They go without a huddle. Carruth reset, the inside handoff to Fagan, and he's down to about the 4-yard line before he is brought down. It'll be second down and goal to go for Alabama. They have it at the Illinois 4-yard line. Bear Bryant, final game in his career, trying to notch number 323.
Walter Lewis had over 2,000 yards total offense this year. 1,500 of that was in the pass. And as you can see, he can run the ball.
Inside handoff, touchdown! Ricky Moore, the sophomore fullback, going in from the double wing. Well, the Liberty Bowl represents America. This is Americana here as we look at the replay of Ricky Moore, the sophomore from Huntsville, Alabama, with a gaping hole. And throughout the evening, we are going to be showing you slices of Americana here in our Liberty Bowl telecast. As Alabama lines up for the conversion, Paul Fields will hold, and Peter Kim from Honolulu will attempt the extra point for the Crimson Tide. It is good. So Alabama has struck through the air, and with the score, Alabama 7, Illinois nothing. We'll be back after this. Timex time left in the first quarter. Alabama will be kicking off to Illinois. Alabama leading 7-0 on the touchdown run by Alabama's sophomore fullback Ricky Moore.
The big play, of course, is Walter Lewis's pass. He was 2 for 3 for 69 yards to date.
That's Dwight Beverly ready to take the kickoff.
Dwight Beverly's one of 22 members of the Illinois football team from the state of California, Harry.
Harry Sanders gets the kickoff. This is Beverly for Illinois. Beverly gets up to about the 28-yard line before he's upended. Illinois will have it first and 10 at their own 28. Mike Pitts, the All-American at one end defensively for Alabama. Their tackles Jackie Klein, the nose guard Mike Rodriguez. The other tackle, Randy Edwards, who blocked the field goal attempt by Illinois. And Russ Wood is the defensive end. First and 10 for the Illini. They have it at their 29-yard line. Tony Eason, 6'4", 205 pounds. Senior, junior college transfer.
Illinois once again are going with a double tight end. Offense, one setback.
Eason gets his pass away, nearly picked off. Nearly intercepted by Rocky Colburn, the safety for Alabama. Incomplete, it'll be second down and 10. Eddie Lowe, the leading tackler for Alabama, one linebacker along with Scott McRae. Their secondary, Jeremiah Castile, an All-American, Stan Gay at the other corner. And the safeties, Tommy Wilcox, who's a two-time All-American, and Rocky Colburn. It is second down and 10, Illinois. They have the ball at their own 29-yard line. Alabama leads 7-0. Eason being rushed, gets it away, a screen pass. It's caught at the 27, up over the 40 for a first down. Goes Joe Curtis. Curtis, the tailback, picks up an Illinois first down at the 41-yard line.
And the play shows the diversity of the Illinois passing attack. They'll pass upfield, they'll quick screen, they'll throw a normal screen like we just saw, and they're capable of making big plays for the rest of this football game.
It is first and 10, Illinois. They have it at their own 41-yard line. Eason again back to pass. Eason gets it away finally. It is incomplete. His intended receiver, the tight end, Tim Brewster. Wherever you're watching, we welcome you on Metro Sports, the 24th annual Liberty Bowl, as we look at Mike White, the head coach of the Fighting Illini. 120 commercial stations across the country, and this game also being seen around the world on the Armed Services Television Network, live and direct in Mexico. Glad to have you with us. Special welcome to our viewers in New York City watching on WPIX. Second down and 10 for Illinois. They have the ball at their own 41-yard line. Illinois, a little confusion as far as their alignment. Eason back to pass, and it is incomplete, in and out of the grasp of Joe Curtis. Would have only been for about 3 yards. Good coverage by Alabama's Tommy Wilcox.
Alabama's mixing up their alignment. They're going from a two-deep zone look to a man-to-man look.
Stan Gay was right there for Alabama. Third down and 10, Illinois. Back to pass, Eason. He's going deep, and it's incomplete. He overshot his intended receiver.
Eason has not got his rhythm yet in this game. I mean, he's passing well. I think Alabama have not gotten to him yet with their pass rush. But Eason hasn't really settled down and played the type of game that he's going to play for the rest of the night.
It was intended for Kirby Wilson. Eason is 4 for 10 tonight, 43 yards thus far. Chris Sigourney coming in to punt for Illinois. Sigourney, junior out of Elgin, Illinois, averages 40.9 per punt, partially blocked. But he gets an Illinois roll, and it goes down to the Alabama 26-yard line.
Coach Bryant's teams have won 322 football games, and they've done it by being a hard-hitting football team. And that's what we're seeing today. Big rush on the punt there, blocked field goal. Hard-hitting football teams. The Bear Bryant.
7:59 left to play first quarter with the score. Alabama 7, Illinois nothing. We'll be back after this. Alabama leads 7-0, 7:59 left to play. here in the first quarter. The Tide has the ball first and 10 at their own 26-yard line. Alabama, surprisingly, has passed for 69 yards, rushed for 36. Inside handoff and a gaping hole.
Alabama, on the other hand, will use the run to make their yards and use the pass to make the big play.
Illinois defensively, Terry Cole at one end. Dan Gregus will be at a defensive tackle along with Don Thorpe. And the other defensive end is Nick Epps. Ricky Moore on the play, picking up 7 yards. It's second down and 3 on the broken wishbone. Back to pass, Lewis. He's going to be sacked, and he is nailed. Brought down hard by Archie Carter, the blitzing linebacker. So Carter blitzed from the linebacker spot, and nobody picked him up, and Walter Lewis had barely time to get back. Linebackers, Bird, Wine grabbed their leading tackler for Illinois, and Carter, who just made the sack. In the secondary, Dennis Bishop at one corner. The other corner is Mike Heaven at the safeties. Will be David Edwards and Craig Swope replacing Mark Jones. Swope a freshman. Lewis back to pass, gets the screen. Oh, it's well set up. Alabama up to the 30, 35, fights for a first down. A well set up screen pass to Ricky Moore, the fullback.
Here we see the versatility of the wishbone. Fake the drop back pass. Three linemen out in front. Secondary's got to come up and make the play. Hard running. The back knew how much he had to get for the first down, and he got upfield and he got it.
He had Mott Sism and Kaya back all there to lead the charge on a screen pass. First and 10, Alabama at the 37-yard line, their own 37. On the option play, Lewis going to keep. Now he pitches back. Running room and a first down by Jeff Fagan.
The running quarterback puts tremendous pressure on the Illinois defense. That keeps the end at home. Here he comes upfield. Where's the cornerback?
Walter Lewis, the quarterback, the second leading rusher for Alabama this year. Another first down. Bama, they have the ball at the 45 of Illinois. From the wishbone. Hand off goes to the fullback, Ricky Moore. Moore, their leading rusher, picks up a couple of grudging yards, and that is about all before he's stacked up by the Illini front.
You saw in that starting lineup, I believe, 4 or 5 defensive people from the state of California. Mike White.
It'll be second down and 9 for Alabama at the Illinois 44-yard line. Inside handoff again to the fullback again, Ricky Moore.
Ricky Moore rushed for 605 yards on the year with an average of 5.4.
Stopped by Pete Muldrone, the defensive tackle, a 240-pounder.
Well, you know, Ricky Moore is only 6 feet tall, but he's 235 pounds. He's a hard man to bring down.
He is tough to break down. Led the Tide in rushing last year as a freshman, this year as a sophomore. Crimson Tide with third down and 5. Lewis on the option play, keeps first down and then some. Inside the Illinois 25 to the 22. Finally brought down by Dennis Bishop at the 22-yard line.
Here you see the tremendous fake, the fullback. The linebacker took the inside charge. Walter Lewis has all that running room, gets upfield. Tremendous athlete to be able to throw the ball the way he does and also be able to run the football. An 18-yard gain, tremendous athlete.
National punt, pass, and kick champion at the age of 8 was this man, Walter Lewis.
6'1", 209 pounds.
Lewis back to pass. Oh, he is pressured. Fumbles the football. Recovers his own fumble, but way back at the 42. David Edwards on a safety blitz for Illinois.
And the safety blitz primarily is to come up and stop the run. And once again, showing how good an athlete he is, he's able to get the right bounce and keep control of the football.
Illinois that time brought safety David Edwards along with linebacker Archie Carter. A big loss on the play back at the 43-yard line, where it brings up second down and 21. Lewis in trouble. He's dropped again. This time number 53 for Illinois comes in to make the hit.
I think it's going to be that kind of a defense for Illinois today. They're going to have to gamble, bring linebackers, bring safeties to stop the run and take their chances against the pass.
You know, 53 is a familiar name. Mark Butkus.
Yes.
The nephew of Illinois' great linebacker Dick Butkus.
What
you,
a great...
you saw him a few times in your numbers, didn't you?
Up too close. The great one.
Back at the 47-yard line, third down and very long, and an inside line play goes nowhere, and Alabama will have to punt it away. Getting up off the bottom of the pile for Illinois, Archie Carter.
I would think this is a tremendous uplifting moment for the Illinois Fighting Illini to be able to stop Alabama. This Alabama going for the quick punt here.
This is Malcolm Simmons, eighth in the nation in punting, 43.3 yards per punt. Kirby Wilson and Mike Martin are back. Fair catch called, and then it rolls dead at the 2-yard line. What a great save. Looked like number 52 for Alabama was down to save it, Anthony Smiley.
44-yard punt.
And no return, save from going into the end zone by Smiley of Alabama. So Illinois will start in the shadow of their goalposts as Mike White, the third-year coach for the Fighting Illini, looks on. With the score, Alabama 7, Illinois nothing. We'll be back after this. The 1983 Metro Sports season will bring basketball fans the excitement of the best in major college basketball with these conference packages. Starting off the new year will be the fast-paced action of the Big Ten, the competitiveness of great independent basketball featuring DePaul, Marquette, and Notre Dame, plus the hard-battling teams of the Big Eight. Check your local listings for all of these outstanding Metro Sports basketball matchups. 7-0 Alabama, Illinois will start at their own 2-yard line.
The smell of bears in the air.
And it's a passing offense still, even at their own 2-yard line. They'll throw anywhere on the field. One running back, and that's Mike Murphy, the fullback. Eason, just a quick out, has his man to the 10-yard line. A quick out to Mike Martin, the fine split-end senior from Washington, D.C.
There's the great man, 322 wins. All-time great.
Six national championships during his tenure at Alabama, 61, 64, 65, 73, 78, and 79. Second down and two, a running play and a rare one for Illinois. The ball carrier was Joe Curtis. He is close to a first down.
They got into a two-back set, which would indicate that they are probably more likely to run the football.
It is enough for the first down for Illinois.
Mike White's got a little bit of a sad look on his face.
Oh, in the last 17 years, Illinois has had only three winning seasons, two of those coming under Mike White, who has really turned this program around. Eason to pass. Got a man wide open, Martin. Martin to the 40 and then to the 47-yard line.
Interestingly enough, that's off a play pass. Mike doesn't look so sad now.
Mike Martin, what a fine receiver he is. Let's watch it.
Here we are. Little fake draw, fake dive. Receiver found the seam right up, right in between the safety and the corner, 35-yard completion. Mike Martin has now caught a lot of passes. 33 games in a row.
69 receptions during the regular season. He's caught three tonight, first to 10, Illinois at the 47-yard line. Decent to throw. He's got a man. His tight end in Alabama territory goes Tim Brewster.
And Eason is now, he's got his rhythm. He's getting back, getting set. He threw that ball right on the money to one of his tight ends on the breakout with a man-to-man coverage.
Time out for a measurement. It is close to a first down.
Brewster. 12 straight catches by the tight end.
Brewster out of Newark, New Jersey, 6'4", 220-pound junior.
Second down.
He had 46 receptions on the season, 550 yards. And, Harry, that's always a good statistic. Is if your tight end is catching the ball, I believe your passing attack has a better chance of having success.
Illinois has a second down and inches. Mitchell Brookins comes in, along with Richard Riles. On a second down and inches call. Brookins.
Split backs. Alabama in a blitz position.
Eason's going to throw for the first down. Look out. He gets it away. It's caught by Oliver Williams. Inside the Alabama 20-yard line is Oliver Williams.
Eason was hit very hard on the play. Zone coverage just shows the ability of the Illinois receivers to get open.
Jeremiah Castillo finally made the tackle on Williams.
That was not one of Jeremiah's better plays. Jeremiah's a senior, had 7 interceptions on the season. The number 17 turned him around pretty good.
And with a timeout at the end of the first quarter, we're looking back at Coach Bear Bryant's illustrious career, his coaching days at Texas A&M. We'll be back after this.
To think what would happen if Tony Eason goes down for Illinois. His backup quarterback is named Chris Jenner. I was talking to him in the hotel lobby last night. He's only thrown 3 passes all year, completing 1. He's a straight 5-0 average. His major course is pre-med. He says if he has the opportunity, he thinks he's ready. Well, a few minutes ago, Eason got flattened. He was slow to get up. And I know the Illini fans are happy he's back in there. They're driving for a touchdown.
The Alabama 18-yard line. Tony Eason at quarterback. Spreads them out into their passing offense. The Alabama 18, the second quarter underway. A running play and not much there. Mike Murphy, the ball carrier, picked up a couple of yards.
Eason is now 8 for 14, 120 yards, and the second quarter just starting. One key to note about the Illinois attack. Obviously, when Eason has enough time to throw, he's going to be very successful. More than that, he's got tremendous receivers. Martin right now has 3 catches for 61 yards. Oliver Williams, 2 catches for 25 yards. And there's 9 other receivers that can catch the ball for the Fighting Illini.
That was Thomas Rooks on the last carry. He picked up about a yard. That's all. So Eason back to the air. Looks to the end zone. Good coverage by Alabama, and Eason runs it out of bounds at the 15-yard line. A pickup of 2. It'll bring up a 3rd down and 7.
Alabama mixing their zone defense down inside the 20. Most teams try to go to man-to-man. Illinois feeling they can hit the individual one-on-one against anybody, like most great passing attacks. Alabama mixing it up with his own defense. Fine coverage. Eason had to run the football.
There you see the 3rd down conversions, and our welcome to our paid television markets. Those viewing this game in Dallas, Washington, and Cincinnati.
Alabama up in a blitz, dropping out now.
3rd down and 7. Eason wants to throw for it. Sideline pattern, close to a 1st down. I don't think he got there. Oliver Williams.
This is a... As you can see, the corner is laying off. Oliver Williams does it, just a quick turn in. Great corner play. The corner gave him maybe just a little too much room, but but came up and made a great hit. Who is that corner?
Jeremiah Castile, but we have a flag down on the play, and it appears the penalty is against Illinois.
The 10-yard
on the isolation, you can see that the Alabama cornerback is playing way off. Illinois will take advantage of that.
Holding on the offense.
That's a problem with a passing attack.
Illinois has been a heavily penalized team all year.
Really, over 800 yards, and that's a lot to make up for.
A lot of yardage and penalties. So it is a 10-yard penalty, bringing up a third down and 18 for Illinois. Eason being blitzed, gets it away, and it is intercepted by Alabama at the 13-yard line. Jeremiah Castile.
Here's a sprint out to the wide side of the field, but it was a throwback all the way. Eason threw it off balance. Really wasn't open. Jeremiah Castile
makes a habit of intercepts. He had 7 this year. He's had 16 in his career. And that's an all-time Alabama career record. Shattered the mark previously held by Harry Gilmer. First and 10, Alabama. They have it at their 13-yard line. They lead 7-0.
The defensive coordinator for Alabama is Ken Donahue. I think he should get some credit for the way the Alabama defense came through in that last series.
Ken Coley is now the quarterback, senior from Birmingham, Alabama. Coley in a quarterback for Alabama. Running play gets him a couple of yards. Ball carrier was Craig Turner, a sophomore from Gaithersburg, Maryland.
You know, one nice thing that I think most coaches across the country should learn from Coach Bear Bryant, the coach likes to play a lot of players. He'll play a lot of running backs. He gets a lot of men into the football game. I like that.
Coley, the senior quarterback, calling signals. Inside handoff and a big hole and a first down for Alabama on the wishbone. Again, the ball carrier was fullback Craig Turner. Alabama enjoys good second quarters. We are in the second quarter at the 24th annual Liberty Bowl, and Alabama leads Illinois 7-0. First and 10, Alabama at their 24-yard line.
Illinois' strong safety is up in a position to blitz. Here he comes. Fumble.
Fumble. Coley fumbled the football. Illinois has recovered. Coley, the quarterback, fumbled the football and pouncing on that ball for Illinois. Ken Gillen, the defensive end, a senior from Arlington Heights, Illinois.
If there's any negative about the Alabama wishbone offense, 42 fumbles on the season and 23 losses.
With the score, Alabama 7, Illinois nothing. We'll be back after this. Here's Ken Coley, the quarterback. You see the fumble. Illinois really stacked it up, and Gillen recovered for the Illini. First and 10, Illinois. They have it at the Alabama 25 after the turnover. Eason to pass up the middle. It is caught at the 1-yard line. Ball jarred loose. Is it a fumble or incomplete? What a hit by the Alabama secondary on Dwight Beverly. They jarred his helmet off. Beverly was really rocked.
Well, there shows you the potency of the Illinois offense. It's a sprint out to the wide side. Throw back across the middle, post pattern to the running back. Tremendous hit.
Jeremiah Castile,
there
the All-American.
The man is a heavy hitter.
He is a heavy hitter. We now pause 5 seconds for our local stations to identify themselves. This is the 1982 Liberty Bowl Metro Sports Television Network. Welcome back to the 24th annual Liberty Bowl. Harry Callis along with Joe Kaff, a jam-packed house where Alabama leads Illinois 7-0. Welcome also to our 20 million viewers watching on ESPN. First and 10 for Alabama. They'll have it at their own 6-yard line, and The All-American cornerback for Alabama, Jeremiah Castile, has made his presence felt tonight.
Yes, he has. I mean, every coach in the country, every young man, you're playing high school football, sandlot football, wherever you're playing, that's the way to hit on defense.
With the score, Alabama 7, Illinois nothing. We'll be back after this.
Extremely upset with the last call. In fact, the referee came over during the discussion and explained to Mike he didn't see it. The coach says, you're taking the game away from him. Let us play out there. Field conditions remain fairly good despite all the rain in Memphis.
Ken Coley, a quarterback for Alabama. Inside handoff. Very little there for Lenny Patrick. If anything, Lenny Patrick, the junior from Jasper, Alabama, stopped in his tracks by the down four of Illinois. It'll be a second down and 10, Alabama. They have it at their own 6-yard line. Alabama leads 7-0, 12:20 left to play in the second quarter. From the wishbone, Coley calling signals. Hand off inside to his fullback, Craig Turner, the sophomore. Turner gets up over the 10 to about the 11-yard line. A pickup of 5, bringing on a second down and 5.
Coley is not a passing quarterback. He only threw 10 passes all season long, and I'm sure Illinois know this, and they're going to defense Coley accordingly.
It's a third down and 5.
Illinois got 8 men up on the line.
Coley only threw 10 passes during the regular season. On the option play, Coley keeps, and he's short of a first down. He stopped at the 14-yard line. Mark Butkus gets up off the bottom of the pile. And it's fourth down and a punting situation for Alabama. Their fine punter, Malcolm Simmons, who averages 43.3 per punt. Malcolm's dad, Dr. Earl Simmons, played football and baseball at Vanderbilt. Eighth leading punter of the nation, Simmons. Gets a short, wobbly boot away. Takes a Illinois roll as it rolls dead at the 46, and Illinois will have good field position. First and 10 at the Alabama 46-yard line. Just 33 yards on the punt by Simmons, far below his average. With 10:56 Timex time left here in the second quarter, the ball is on the Alabama 47-yard line, first and 10 Illinois, and Alabama leading 7-0. So Tony Eason will go to work again.
Split backfield.
Eason back to pass, has time, firing to the sideline. It's incomplete. He overshot his intended receiver. Out of the backfield, that was Mitchell Brookins. Brookins is an interesting story. The intended receiver, junior from Chicago, Illinois. He scores a touchdown every 4.7 times he touches the ball. Mitchell Brookins.
What you call your scoring specialist.
I'll tell you. It is second down and 10. Illinois with the ball at the 47-yard line of Alabama. Eason gets it away, tight end open, but it's incomplete. He had it and couldn't hang on. Brewster was the intended receiver, and he was hit hard by Rocky Colbert.
I would guess that was an audible. There's a big hole in the secondary, the big seam. Quarterback throws the ball on the money. But Alabama says if you're going to catch it, you're going to pay.
And they have made him pay. Rocky Colburn with that hit. Earlier it was Jeremiah Castile that made a hit at the 2-yard line, forcing a fumble. And with the score, Alabama 7, Illinois nothing. We'll be back after this. Fourth annual Liberty Bowl, a sellout as Alabama leads Illinois 7-0. 10:43 left. In the second quarter, Illinois has a third and 10 at the Alabama 47-yard line. Tony Eason, straight back, has some time. Double pumps, runs out of trouble, gets it away, and it is nearly picked off by Cass Steele. He did pick it off. Second interception of the game by Jeremiah Cass Steele.
A lot of time on the play. A lot of people coming open. Castile played off the receiver just enough to come up and take the gamble and make the interception.
Well, you see why that man is an All-American. Jeremiah Castile has made two interceptions tonight.
I think it's just a matter of time, though. Illinois is going to get some completions in here. And Alabama better capitalize on these turnovers.
First and 10, Alabama. They have the ball at their 22-yard line. Walter Lewis back in at quarterback. The handoff goes to his fullback, Craig Turner. And Turner moves the ball up to about the 28-yard line. Pick up on the play of right around 6 yards by Turner. It'll be second down and four. There you see Bear Bryant's bowl record, 14-12-2. There on that handoff for Alabama. Once again, it was Craig Turner, the fullback, the ball carrier. Might have picked up a yard, brings on a third down and three for Alabama at the 29-yard line.
Since the opening drive, Alabama has not used the play pass. They're maintaining their running attack.
This is how Illinois' defense looks at that wishbone.
But don't ever forget the fact that Alabama can't come up with that long, big play.
Alabama did not get the first down on that call. Gain of a couple of yards on the play.
Fagan is leading the leading rusher with 5 carries, 37 yards.
Here's a fourth down for Alabama. They have the ball at their own 31-yard line. I think it's a fourth down. I don't believe they made it. I think they have to get to the 32, and it's just shy of the 32-yard line. Did not make it. Fourth down. And Bear Bryant will have the decision here. Does he go for it, or does he punt it away? And it appears that the Bear has decided to go for it.
Nope.
Sends in the kicking team. Two punts, 38 yards so far for Malcolm Simmons. The legend in his final game. His head football coach after 322 victories.
They are going to go for it. And they are not going to go for it.
Malcolm Simmons. That's a low punt away. Hits at the 40, takes an Alabama bounce, and rolls all the way down to the Illinois 23-yard line. Where it'll be down, and it'll be first and 10. So Simmons helped his average with that punt thanks to a nice roll. He got 37 yards on that one. Bear Bryant has had 8 undefeated teams during the regular season in his career. There's his record. While at the helm of the Crimson Tide of Alabama, 231 of his 322 coaching wins. First and 10, Illinois. They'll have it at their 23-yard line. Alabama leads 7-0, 8:59 left to play. We're in the first half.
Double tight, one setback.
Eason rolling out, looks upfield, being pursued, and he is driven out of bounds on a fine defensive play by the All-American and Mike Pitts. Pitts, the senior defensive end from Baltimore, Maryland.
Mike Pitts, he actually is a strong side linebacker. He's only 6'5", 255 pounds from Baltimore, Maryland.
Had 7 sacks during the regular season and 82 tackles.
He's their big play man.
Ball back at the 18-yard line, a loss of 5, second and 15 for Illinois. Eason on the handoff. Not much there, because once again, Mike Pitts, number 81, there to stop Joe Curtis. After a gain of 2, it'll be third down and 13. There's the All-American defensive end, Joe Pitts, or rather Mike Pitts, 6'5", 255 pounds.
7-0. Alabama leading Illinois. Welcome to our viewers on KRIV in Houston. Our broadcast partner Lowell Pass and Gang watching there in Houston. Also those watching in Honolulu, KITV in Honolulu. After a fake to the left, goes right, got some running room, does Murphy, and Murphy is really nailed at the 37-yard line. He got the first down, but my, did he pay.
Screen pass, good call, fake out to the right, secondary dropping off, they caught him in his own defense. Mike Murphy picking his, finding his way there.
Ooh.
But he...
he paid. Number 97 on the tackle for Alabama, that's Robbie Jones, a linebacker. First and 10, Illinois, though, at the 37-yard line. Here's a wide pitch, Curtis the ball carrier, and Curtis gets about one as Alabama strings it out nicely. Making the tackle once again was Mike Pitts. So the Alabama All-American defensive players, Mike Pitts defensive end, Jeremiah Castile defensive corner, have been very prominent for the Crimson Tide today.
They play great team defense, hard-hitting defense.
Second down and 10 for Illinois. They have it at their own 37-yard line. Eason finally gets it away. He's got his man at the 35, up to the 40, and a first down. Thomas Rooks. There is a marker down in the play. Rooks got enough yardage for the first down, the freshman from St. Louis, Missouri.
Eason was looking to throw a screen pass out to his left. His linemen were out forming the screen. It did not look good to Tony, so he came back to the right side of the field to an open receiver and made the first down. Unless this penalty will prevent it.
Here it is, Eason, so maneuverable out there.
And Beverly.
There was a clip.
Thomas Rooks, the running back. Once again, some heavy hitting from the Alabama secondary.
So the penalty will bring it back and move it to the 34-yard line where it's second down and 13. Kirby Wilson was called for a clip, and with the score, Alabama 7 and Illinois nothing. We'll be back after this. Most valuable player of the game later on this evening. Right now, the front runner would have to be Alabama defensive back Jeremiah Castile, who has intercepted two passes, forced to fumble at the 2-yard line. Illinois will have the ball at their 34-yard line where it's second down and 13. Tony Eason brings him out. Third in the nation in total offense. Eason pumps. Now he wants his Martin, and it's incomplete. Martin, his favorite receiver, incomplete. Defending on the play was Stan Gay. And it's third down and 13.
The crowd here thinking possible interference in the call. And as you look around the stadium, Harry, you see a lot of orange. A lot of people came down from the great state of Illinois to see this football game.
And, of course, an awful lot of Tide faithful to watch this man, the legend, coaching in his final game.
Tony Eason now, 50%.
Third down, 13. Welcome to our viewers watching on WGN-TV Chicago. He's got his man, Oliver Williams, first down at the Alabama 49. Ball comes loose, but the whistle blew it dead. Oliver Williams, a senior from Inglewood, California, the receiver, and it's first down, Illinois.
Tony Eason is 62% on the season, so he's going to pass over 50%. Here he gets fine protection. It's a curl-in pattern to his wideout. Finds the hole in the seam, drops it in. Oliver Williams.
First, go ahead, Joe.
Oliver Williams, 9'6" speed in the 100.
There's a marker down on the play before the play started.
Illegal procedure, Illinois, will cost them five. As we mentioned earlier, Illinois, a heavily penalized team.
They had over 800 yards of penalties on the season.
False start, offense, first down.
Illinois are shifting from a double tight formation and taking one of the receivers and spreading him out. They're trying to spread the Alabama defense.
On his first and 15, facing Tony Eason. There are Eason's stats. He owns 9 NCAA passing marks. Eason gets it away. Coming back to grab it is Oliver Williams at the Alabama 38. It's a first down.
And for you young high school quarterbacks, watch Tony Eason get his depth. No false step, gets good depth, looks upfield, finds the man in the hole, delivers the football. And you receivers, notice how Oliver came back to make the catch. Came back to the football.
So Illinois has it first and 10 at the Alabama 38-yard line. 7-0 Alabama, 5:50 left to play, second quarter. Eason wants Kirby Wilson. He's got him at the 25-yard line. Knocked out of bounds at the 25. Knocked out by Stan Gay. But it's a first down, Illinois. Kirby Wilson, the receiver.
It's man-to-man coverage. Cornerback playing off just enough. A lot of Illinois people thought that was a little bit of a late hit.
First and 10, Illini. They have it at the Alabama 24-yard line.
Illinois receivers, it's impossible to cover them one-on-one all game long. Alabama's got to mix it up.
Got his tight end. Inside the 20 to the 16-yard line goes Tim Brewster, who was hurt earlier. Back in the game, makes a key reception there. Not enough for the first down. It'll be second down and about 3. Brewster second only to Mike Martin in receptions for the Illini this year.
A great core of receivers. Nine players caught over double figures in receptions all season long.
A running play for the Illini, and a running play good for only 1 yard by Richard Riles, the junior from San Jose, California.
One of 22 players from the great state of California on the Illinois roster.
So it's third down and about 1.5 yards to go for the first down. 15 to go for a touchdown.
A little bit of indecision here. Player Dwight Beverly trying to get on the field with the play. Had to run off.
Riles, the lone running back behind Eason. Eason's going to throw for the first down.
It's man-to-man coverage.
Eason. It is caught. A great catch by number 40 for Illinois, Cam Benson. Junior from Lauderhill, Florida.
Great reception. Flat out diving for the ball. Great concentration. Sprint out to the right. Man-to-man coverage. One-on-one. Beautiful play.
Cam Benson, junior, 5'11", 170-pounder. First and goal, Illinois. They have it at the Alabama 8-yard line. And has two running backs behind
him. Too much time.
Delay of game penalty called against Illinois. And again, that penalty bugaboo really hurting the Fighting Illini. Moves it back by.
They seem to have some problems getting the play in from the sideline.
First and goal.
I believe Coach White calls the plays himself.
So it's still first and goal from the 13-yard line.
Here's how it looks from down on the field.
Oliver Williams in motion. Eason gets a pass away. It's caught inside the 5-yard line by Oliver Williams.
There's a new formation we haven't seen yet today. sprint out to the wide side of the field. Eason shows how he can throw, running to his left. Fine completion. Oliver Williams once again.
Williams has caught a lot of Eason passes tonight.
5 catches, 54 yards.
It is second down and goal, Illinois. Being pursued, gets it away, intercepted at the 2-yard line, all the way back to the 21. Picked off by Alabama. Johnny Elias, the junior from Columbus, Georgia. Intercepts have really hurt the Illini and Tony Eason tonight.
John Elias, a down lineman, dropping off into the coverage.
That's a 239-pounder running back that interception.
Look at those moves. North and south, Don.
First and 10. There you see the turnovers. They've been costly to Illinois.
Lewis, the play pass.
Lewis throws, and it is intercepted. Illinois at the 40-yard line. Back to the 25, the 20, and down to the 16-yard line goes Dennis Bishop. Dennis Bishop, the senior from San Francisco, California. So Alabama turns it right back over to Illinois.
Well, you live by the sword, you die by the sword. Fine interception.
Joey Jones, the intended receiver, Bishop stepping right in front of him. So Illinois back in business at the Alabama 15-yard line. Tony Eason on first and 10. Eason being pursued, just throws one up, got his man, Martin, inside the 10 to about the 8-yard line. So, boy, under heavy pressure, too.
Heavy pressure. The man is wide open, the receiver. I don't see quite who he is. But this ball was put up there. If Mike Martin hadn't have been wide open, once again, that could have been picked off. And the Illinois look. And once again, pays a heavy price for making the catch.
Tackled by Jeremiah Castile at second down and 3 for a first down. Hand off Beverly, has the first down inside the 5-yard line. Or rather, Curtis, the ball carrier. Joe Curtis, the ball carrier. Has an Illinois first down at the Alabama 4-yard line. Mike White completing a 7-4 year. Collegiate coach of the year in 75.
First and of goal. Course, he was coaching the University of California Golden Bears in 1975.
Paul Bear Bryant. 3 times National Coach of the Year. This is his grand finale. Curtis, the ball carrier, gets a block, gets to the 1-yard line. Joe Curtis brought down at the 1-yard line.
Joe Curtis knows where that goal line is. He's fought real hard to get the yardage that he got.
Robbie Jones, the tackle for Alabama. It's second down and goal to go. Illinois breaks the huddle. Second down and goal. Curtis. Diving, touchdown Illinois. Curtis broke the play to the end zone before being pushed back. Good lead block by his fullback, Mike Murphy.
Very close play, very close. And I noticed that the Illinois band are out on the field. We will see how close right here. Very close.
Awfully close. The official on the far side said he broke the play, so it's touchdown, Illinois. Mike Bass, will attempt the conversion.
The Illinois band is right in behind the end zone.
Bass's extra point is wide. Mike Bass wide on the extra point, and he hasn't missed one of those in a long time. So Alabama has a one-point lead with 1:03 left to play in the first half. 7-6 Alabama.
Mike Bass was 32 out of 33 extra points on the season, 23 out of 26 field goals. Fine kicker.
101 points he scored, shattering the Illinois mark held by Red Grange. Let's go down now to Johnny Holliday.
Harry and Joe, you wonder about the weather conditions on the foot of Mike Bass. He's been used to kicking all year long on AstroTurf. Tonight here at the Liberty Bowl, this is natural grass. But I got to think the coldness of this evening has something to do with his kicking. He's missed a field goal and the extra point, and how close that was to the goal line. Bear Bryant, the coaching staff, the Alabama players, not quite so sure he was across the goal line. But a super first half, 7-6 Alabama.
Mike Bass is a barefoot kicker, and perhaps the cold could hurt it. Also, Joe, this is the first time this year he has kicked on natural grass. It's always been the artificial surfaces. So maybe that's a factor. At any rate, Bass will kick off. High boot taken by Joey Jones, and he squirts to the 20-yard line where Alabama will have it first and 10. At their own 20-yard line. Alabama leading by a point. Less than a minute to play in the first half.
Well, theoretically, this is where a wishbone team is at a disadvantage because they don't have that long bomb threat with the pass.
Walter Lewis, the quarterback from Gruden, Alabama, 6'1", 205 pounds. First and 10. The 18-yard line. Lewis keeps the ball. Lewis has some running room up over the 35 to the 40 on the option play. Goes Walter Lewis.
That's what I said, theoretically.
51
Lewis,
seconds.
They gave him the option. He took it. 20-some-yard run.
Yeah, Lewis picked up on that play, 22 yards. First and 10, Alabama.
I see the Illinois linebackers digging in a little harder this time. Here's the pitch.
Pitch back on the option play. Headed on that play about 7 yards.
But the second hands tick down, 31 seconds.
Paul Carruth, the ball carrier. Alabama calls time to stop the clock. 31 seconds left to play in the first half. Alabama leading 7-6 in the 24th annual Liberty Bowl. Well, you know, Coach Paul Bear Bryant in his last game as a head football coach certainly has influenced the lives of thousands of people, his players, his assistant coaches. He's led to some coaching careers. Here are some of the men who have played under him or coached with him who are now head coaches. Jackie Sherrill, Steve Sloan, Howard Schnellenberger, Bum Phillips, Ray Perkins, Charlie Pell, Bill Oliver, Al Kincaid, Danny Ford, Pat Dye, Charlie Bradshaw, to mention just a few.
And never mind the great players that he coached. Joe Namath, Kenny Stabler.
Well, we have an outstanding halftime show for you lined up, and of course the Liberty Bowl always puts on a great pageant. This year it's the music of Memphis. Memphis is the birthplace of the blues, Joe. Be quite a show. Lewis is going to throw for it. Gets his pass away. It's picked off by Illinois again. That's Bishop. Bishop's second interception. Bishop looking for some running room and finally is swarmed under.
Might have been looking for somebody to lateral to.
He was hit very hard by Ricky Moore, the fullback.
Looking at it from the Illinois defensive vantage point, very poor throw. Illinois in a zone coverage, almost to prevent.
That's Bishop's second intercept, and Ricky Moore, the fullback, really brought him to the earth in a hurry.
Here's another look. The ball should have never been thrown. But once again, Alabama does not work on the pass and are at a disadvantage when they're only when they're trying to play catch-up football.
Eason steps up, slips, is in trouble, gets away, still looking, gets it away, and it is incomplete. 6 seconds left to play in the first half. It'll be second down and 10, Illinois.
Eason is nicknamed Tony, supposedly because when he was in his mama's womb, a Mexican friend called him Patón, which means Bigfoot. And he looked like he was doing a little Mexican hat dance there.
Well, the legend Paul Bear Bryant has himself a 1-point lead in this his final game here as a head coach.
Here we see a trips formation, three wide receivers all out to the wide side of the field. And I would guess that Coach Mike White will put the ball up in the air and go for it with 6 seconds remaining in this first half.
One of Bear's former assistants, Pat James, had a good story about Paul Bear Bryant. Bear, during meetings sometimes, could be a little tough on people. In one particular meeting with his coaches, he really aired out Pat James on one side and down the other, gave him a good chewing out. And the next day, James came back to the offices and talked to the other assistants and said, "I really paid Bear back. Really got back at him." He said, "Really? What'd you do?" He said, "Well, I went home and told my wife and kids to get out of the house, closed myself in the closet, and just really cussed him out." Really got back at him, huh?
The man has presence.
Yeah, Bud Dudley, the executive director of the Liberty Bowl, said that there are few people who can walk into a room, as in the luncheon the other day, with 3,000 people in attendance, and the room just comes to a dead silence as he walked into the room. Bear Bryant is one of those few that can silence a room of thousands just by his presence.
Here's the three wideouts to the left side. They're going downfield. The ball's going to be 60 yards in the air.
And that is the end of the first half, and Alabama gets another interception and a lateral.
And the ball's still alive.
It is still alive.
A little California play here.
Castile finally brought down at midfield.
That's the kind of half this has been.
And with the score, Alabama 7, Illinois 6. That's the end of the first half. And once again, we're looking back at Coach Bryant's illustrious career and his earlier coaching days. We'll be back after this.
Thank you. Louis Blues. Handy introduced America to the blues, a unique invention of black folk singers. It happened during a political campaign. Handy was commissioned to write a song to help elect Mayor Crump. The song Handy wrote, we know as the legendary Memphis Blues. Soon to follow was the St. Louis Blues and the great Beale Street Blues. But W.C. Handy was just the beginning. There were Memphis names like Isaac Hayes, Clyde McCoy, and of course Elvis Presley. Tonight, right here in our studio, you are going to get to see and hear some of the greatest Memphis musicians. Starting with someone you may not know is from Memphis, but everybody knows him as the Silver Fox, Charlie Rich.
At the Liberty Bowl, the 24th annual Liberty Bowl, a total sellout, Joe Capp, and we've seen a game that has not involved much scoring, 7-6 in the half, and yet it's been a very exciting first half. A lot of head knocking going on down there.
Well, one thing is clear to me, Illinois offense has been it's fearful. They're liable to score at any time. They're liable to make the big play at any time. And I'm sure that Alabama fears the Illinois offense.
All right, Joe, that's how we are at halftime. Let's go back to the pageantry at halftime at the Liberty Bowl and the music of Memphis, the birth of the blues. Illinois 6 will be back after. That's right. Big banner behind the Alabama coach, behind the Alabama bench being paraded here at halftime. Thanks for the memories, coach.
Harry, I'm going to mention Jerry Buckley's name today.
Okay.
Reason I'm going to mention is I told him I would mention it.
Good enough reason, I guess.
Jerry Buckley, one of our hospitable host here, said my name has never been on national TV, and so now it's been on 3 times.
I tell you, I can't imagine any greater hospitality than that which you get here in Memphis, Tennessee. These folks have treated us just royally. The legend. Looking at his team. Paul's going to do a little hunting and fishing. And, of course, will remain as athletic director at Alabama. Sorry for the halftime audio problems that were experienced. Not those of Metro Sports, but rather by the pageant committee. We had some audio troubles on the music of Memphis. There you see Eason's stats for the first half, 247 yards. But 4 intercepts, 2 of them picked off by Jeremiah Castile. Alabama kicking off. Illinois receiving. Boot taken at the 9-yard line. Back up to the 20, 30, up to the 36. Fine run back by Illinois. Brought back by Illinois' number 26, Dwight Beverly. And it's 1st and 10, Illini, as the second half is underway in this 24th annual Liberty Bowl. Alabama leading by a point.
I don't think we'll see anything different from the fighting Illini.
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 Yeah, we had a couple of calls. I was saying Illini, making it a 4-syllable. It's fighting Illini. 3-syllable. My apologies for the fighting Illini. Side handoff for Illinois to Richard Riles, the junior from San Jose, California, 6-foot, 200-pounder. He picked up a couple.
Once again, that gang tackling from the great linebacking core of Alabama.
Eddie Lowe, the brother of San Diego Charger linebacker Woodrow Lowe, is Alabama's leading tackler.
Illinois 3-0 in bowl games, Rose Bowls.
It is 2nd down and 8. Easy's going to put it up. Short pass. There's a marker down on the play. It's complete. It's short of a 1st down. Caught by Richard Riles out of the backfield, but there's a penalty on the play, and the penalty was thrown around the holding area.
Face mask.
Oh, face mask against the offense. Unusual penalty. Evidently an offensive
lineman grabbed a face mask inadvertently. So Illinois will be penalized. The Fighting Illini have suffered a lot of penalties this year. In the first half, 37 yards against Illinois and over 800 yards of penalties during the regular season. That one a face mask violation, so the down remains the same. Second and 13 for Tony Eason.
They're back in their double tight offense.
Eason has some running room, and then he stumbles at the 37-yard line, gets back to about the original line of scrimmage. It'll bring up a third down and 10. Eason runs only when forced to. He does not like to run. He likes to throw the football.
But he's a pretty good athlete. He'll get back up to the line of scrimmage.
Mike Murphy comes in at the running back spot for Illinois, replacing Richard Riles. Third down and 10, Illinois. They have it at their 37-yard line.
Alabama faking the blitz, jumping out into what looks to be a zone coverage now.
Eason, sideline pattern. And he underthrew his intended receiver, who was Mike Murphy, out of the backfield. So it's fourth down, and Illinois' punter, Chris Sigourney, will come on. Sigourney, out of Elgin, Illinois, averaged 40.9 per punt during the regular season. He's punted just once tonight for 33 yards. 7-6 Alabama. Third quarter underway, 13:30 left to play in the third period. Back in safety for the Crimson Tide is Paul Carruth. Averages 10.2 yards per punt return. Sigourney's punt taken by Carruth at the sideline, got back up over the 30, to stepped out of bounds right around the 30-yard line. So Alabama will have it in play, first and 10 at their own 30.
It was only a 35-yard punt, and I'm sure Sigourney is concerned about the big rush that Alabama's put on.
First Alabama bowl game, the 1959 Liberty Bowl. That one was played in Philadelphia. Alabama for the first time. Lewis hands off inside.
The Illinois defensive coordinator, Max McCartney, features a 4-3-4. Strong safety goes to the strong side of the field.
Alabama 1-2 in Liberty Bowl appearances. Their last appearance, big win over UCLA, 36-6. On the option play, Lewis Keats has some running room over the 45 to the 47-yard line. It's a first down, Alabama. Walter Lewis. Stopped by Mo Bias.
You see the tremendous concentration in Walter Lewis's eyes. He sees the hole and gets upfield, north and south.
First and 10, Alabama. They have it at their 47-yard line. From the wishbone, Walter Lewis, junior quarterback, calls the signals.
There's a good shot of the Alabama offensive line.
Lewis puts it in the air, has his receiver, Bendross, and Bendross knocked out of bounds on the far side at the 37-yard line to Jesse Bendross.
And this is what we've got to see from Alabama. They've got to keep the mix, the pass and the run.
Driven out of bounds by Dennis Bishop. First down, Alabama.
Obviously single man-to-man coverage on the part of Illinois, playing too far off.
Wynn held it up, and of course you saw the return. Kim has kicked him 49 yards earlier this season. That is his longest. So you had one field goal miss for each ball club, and let me tell you guys, you're better off upstairs in the booth where it's nice and warm than down here. It's cold.
Johnny, you look warm as toast down there. It's 7-6 Alabama leading by a point with 8:34 left to play, and Alabama has it in good field position. First and 10 at their own 49-yard line. Walter Lewis hands off. Ricky Moore running room inside the 40 to the 36-yard line goes fullback Ricky Moore.
You call it, Harry, good field position.
Archie Carter finally brought him down.
And Walter Lewis now on the game, 3 carries for 53 yards.
Ball at the 37-yard line, a first down, Alabama.
A wishbone with two split ends.
Walter Lewis going to keep it, pitches back, nothing there as Illinois strings it out well at the 35-yard line, a pickup of a couple of yards.
They're running it back to the short side of the field. It looks like it's almost a forward lateral, which would be legal in that he's behind the line of scrimmage.
Would be counted as a pass, though, wouldn't it? In stats.
Who cares? Who cares about stats?
Alabama over UCLA, their last appearance in the Liberty Bowl in 76. Second down and 8. Lewis to throw.
I believe
and it deflected.
I believe it was deflected. Illinois had 8 people up in a position to stop the run, but also obviously to put pressure on the passer.
8 minutes, 7 seconds, Timex time left in the third quarter. The ball is on the Illinois 35-yard line. It's 3rd down and 8, Alabama.
Alabama's got to take advantage of this field position right now.
From the broken wishbone with a wing on the right, 3rd down and 8. They can do it with the pass or with the option. With the pass, Lewis gets it away. Bendris has a first down and then some at the 19-yard line.
Obviously an audible. Walter Lewis changed the play at the line of scrimmage. He saw one-on-one coverage. They have it in their system to throw the quick out. Fine play.
Jesse Bendris, the receiver, he was brought down by Mark Jones after eluding that tackler. Mark Jones nails him at the 19. It's 1st and 10, Alabama. Bendris, 3 catches, 51 yards.
Fine quarterbacking to take advantage of the man-on-man coverage. And we see it again here.
Walter Lewis on the option play. He is dropped. Good defensive play for Illinois by Ken Gillen, number 87, who made the initial hit. And then Pete Mulcrone was right there to drop him as well from Chicago. Mulcrone, 240 pounds. Gillen, 87, tripped him up.
The man that made the play is correct, number 87.
Ball still at the 19. We're at 2nd down and 10. Mike White, head coach of the Fighting Illini. Lewis throwing, wide open.
Put that in the category of taking what they give you.
Wide open was Darryl White, the wideout. And White got it to the 13-yard line. A pickup on the play of right around 6. It brings up a 3rd down and 4. Interesting call here, Joe Kim.
Once again, very important play. I don't think a field goal is going to win this game.
Craig Turner comes in at fullback for Alabama.
At least I think there's going to be more than one field goal scored.
3rd down call for Walter Lewis.
They're dug in. There's 8 people up front.
Inside handoff and inside the 10 to the 8-yard line. It is a 1st down, Alabama.
Credit the right side of the line. Sism, Kayavik.
Bob Kayavik and Willard Sism.
Excuse me, Mom.
Right guard and right tackle. Opening the hole for Craig Turner, who got a 1st down, Alabama at the 8.
Great get off by the Alabama offensive front.
1st and goal, Alabama at the 8-yard line. Yeah. Hand off to Fagan, and he was really rock hard. Brought down on the play by Pete Mulcrone. Mulcrone, the senior from Chicago, Illinois.
Big play by Pete.
Mulcrone has been playing the defensive tackle spot for Dan Gregus. Done a good job. Gain of about a 0.5 yard. 2nd down and goal to go. Lewis on the option play. Swarmed under at the line of scrimmage. No gain on that play.
Coming back to the short side of the field, there's just not enough room to run the option. Fine pursuit by the Illinois defense.
Mark Butkus is right there for Illinois, the junior from Lansing, Illinois, along with Mike Johnson. Third down and goal. The ball's still at the 8-yard line for Alabama. Alabama leads by a point.
A lot of strategy taking place right now. Substitutions.
Walter Lewis sends a man in motion.
Reverse.
Reverse to Bendris, and Bendris has blockers. Touchdown, Alabama. Jesse Bendris. Well-conceived play, and Bendris had all kinds of room.
It's almost like they were setting that play up, coming back to the short side and then reversing it.
Jesse Bendris, the junior from Hollywood, Florida, on the reverse. Here it is.
Fine fake. Good execution. He was gone.
Alabama has taken a 13-6 lead. Peter Kim to attempt the conversion. Spotted by Fields, it's up, and it is good. And with the score, Alabama 14, Illinois 6. We'll be back after this. Here at the Liberty Bowl, 14-6 Alabama leading. Debbie Maffitt, who is Miss America. Debbie, where are you from?
Well, Anaheim, California, but my parents live in Cut and Shoot, Texas.
Cut and Shoot, Texas. You a football fan?
You know, I'm not that big of a sports fan, but after this week and after this game, I think I'm a sports fan.
You kind of like it here in Memphis.
I sure do.
They've done a great job, haven't they?
They really have.
You've been traveling all over, I imagine.
20,000 travel miles a month.
God bless you, Debbie. Thanks a lot for being with us. We appreciate it. Debbie Maffitt, Miss America, is Illinois running it back. This is Beverly, and Beverly all the way to the Alabama 44. A great run back by the Fighting Illini's Dwight Beverly.
Just a fine run back.
Watch it again.
You see it from the Illinois vantage point. You see the formation of the wall. Beverly hits it in there. Finds open ground.
Good effort by Beverly, putting Illinois in good field position. First and 10 at the 44-yard line of Alabama.
Illinois split backs.
Eason back to pass. Got one up the middle to his tight end. That's
what you call a delay twist in.
Tim Brewster got it to the 39-yard line. A pickup of 5. It'll be second down and 5. Johnny Holiday must have been right, because there's Alabama's scoring drive. It was capped on that reverse to Jesse Bendris of 8 yards. Second down and 5. Eason up the middle again. This is his favorite receiver, Mike Martin, for a first down at the 29-yard line.
Well, this is what Illinois can do. They can sit up, drop back, find the open receiver, get good protection. Eason knows he's got to get on the scoreboard now. He's playing with rhythm, playing with confidence. He's way over 200 yards for this game, and there's a lot of time left.
First and 10, Eason straight back, gets it away again up the middle. 3 straight passes up the middle, 2 to the tight end, Brewster, and sandwich in the middle, 1 to Mark. What have they seen in the Alabama defense, Joe?
Well, on that last one, I believe the linebacker was coming in almost what they call a hot pattern. Eason gets the ball to the tight end where the linebacker had vacated.
It is a second down and 5 call for Tony Eason.
They're in their double tight, 1 setback.
And he primarily is a blocker, and that's Mike Murphy. Play action to Murphy. Eason rolls out, being pursued, gets it away, it's incomplete. He's in and out of the grasp of Cam Benson.
Eason is down. I don't know if he's...
He was hit by Mike Pitts. He was hit hard by Mike Pitts and really put the pressure on him. Pitts, the senior All-American defensive end from Baltimore, Maryland.
The play is a misdirection play. It's a, you could call it a bootleg. Fake to the remaining back and then goes wide like a rollout. He's got his Here's Mr. Pitts.
And he welcomes Tony Easton to the Liberty Bowl turf. We'll be selecting the Holiday Inn's most valuable player of the game later on this evening. And with the score, Alabama 14, Illinois 6. We'll be back after this. Alabama leads 14-6, 3:26 to play third quarter. Eason is out of the lineup for the first time tonight for Illinois, and this is Chris Jenner, a junior, 6'5", 220. Not, he has a third down and five call.
And not much playing action all season long. He only threw three passes all year. He was 1 for 3. He's going for the bomb.
It is intercepted. The third interception of the night for Jeremiah Castile.
We don't know what the injury to Tony Easton is. Here's the rollout. Jenner puts it up.
Great coverage by Castile.
Great coverage. There was a little bit of room in the end zone. Jenner could have put the ball further into the end zone.
Alabama has picked off 5 Illinois passes. That's a Liberty Bowl record. And that man, number 19, has picked off 3 of those 5. Alabama, 14-6 lead. First and 10 at their own 20-yard line. Walter Lewis, the quarterback. Lewis on the option. He keeps, and he is dropped on a fine defensive play by number 85 for Illinois. That's Mike Johnson, junior defensive end from Chicago, Illinois. It's second down and 10.
Johnny Holiday on our sideline says that Tony Easton will be back in the game. He's not severely hurt. It was hard to tell what it was. Might have been just a loss of breath.
It is second down and 10. Lewis gonna throw wide open, but just out of the grasp of his wide receiver, Joey Jones from Mobile, Alabama. He was open.
The ball was there. That's the type of catch the receiver has to make.
Third down and 10, Alabama. They have it at the 20-yard line. Alabama leads Illinois 14-6. 2:37 left in the third quarter.
Walter Lewis is 6 for 11, 120 yards. He's had 2 interceptions, but he's mixing it up. Third and 10.
Lewis being pursued. Heavy pressure on him. Gets a block, gets another block.
He's got a lot of room. He's
reversing,
got a man.
Reversing his field. Gets a pass away, and it is caught. Caught inbounds. The Illinois bench saying out of bounds, but it was caught inbounds, according to the official, by Darrell White.
Great scramble by Walter Lewis. So sprint out to the right. Great effort, great pursuit by the Illinois defenders. Walter Lewis has great ability to be active. Receiver found the open spot, and it looks like we have a completion. And you can see right here, he's inbounds.
However, it is being brought back, and there is a penalty, evidently, against Alabama. 5-yard penalty. Penalty and loss of down.
So we will see the punt team come on the field without a huddle.
Find out what it was. Ineligible receiver downfield.
And that can't happen when you have that type of scramble play.
So it's 5 yards and loss of down. Alabama's punter Malcolm Simmons coming in. Johnny Holiday had a point about the winds down there. Neither punter is punting tonight what they average during the season. The winds must be playing tricks with them. Certainly the kicking game. That's not a long one. Fair catch called to the 49 and made by Illinois. And Illinois has it first and 10 in good field position.
Coach White has got his offensive unit firing them up on the sideline. Here they come. It looks like Tony Easton will be coming into the game.
He is. Tony Easton back at quarterback for Illinois.
And there's a penalty on the field.
Another marker down on the field.
There's the man, Jeremiah Castile.
Alabama has set the record for most interceptions by a team. He has tied the record for most interceptions by an individual, three. Now this one's going to be brought back. Penalty has evidently been called against Illinois. Moving it 10 yards to the 25-yard line. Holding penalty against Illinois. Receiving team.
An interesting side note here. Castile is tied with his own coach, Rich Campbell, for that record of interceptions.
Three interceptions?
Excuse me, let me get his name right.
A high, towering punt. Fair catch called and made at the 33-yard line by Martin.
Lewis Campbell, the defensive secondary coach for Alabama. The punt, 43 yards.
And actually, that penalty, the holding penalty on the kick receiving team of Illinois, cost them in that exchange 19 yards, Joe. They had the ball in good field position. Now they're backed up to their 32-yard line.
I don't have the number in front of me, but Illinois has had a lot of penalties that have hurt them and have been very costly to their game tonight.
First and 10, Illinois. They have the ball at their 32-yard line. Tony Eason, the quarterback. Eason missed one play. Eason, the quick out to Martin. Martin at the 37-yard line, dropped immediately, but he picked up 5 yards on the play before Stan Gay made the hit. Stan Gay along with Anthony Smiley making the tackle for Alabama. It's second down and 5, Illinois. Alabama leads 14-6. We have a minute 50 left to play in the third quarter.
Oliver Williams, excuse me. Mike Martin has 6 catches now for 79 yards. Double tight formation. Alabama faking the dog in the blitz. Dropping out into what looks to be a two-man zone deep.
Quick pass to Thomas Rooks, and Rooks has a first down at the Illinois 43-yard line. Just a quick pass to Rooks out of the backfield.
This is what Coach Mike White likes to do. Ball control with the pass. They're very good at it.
Scott McCray making the tackle. Rooks comes out. Coming back in for Illinois is Joe Curtis. First and 10, Illinois. They have it at the 43-yard line, their own 43. Eason straight back.
Ends crossing, across the middle.
Incomplete. It was intended for Mike Martin. Defending on the play, linebacker Robbie Jones.
Alabama once again mixes up their man-to-man coverage, their two-deep zone, their three-deep zone. They're keeping Illinois off balance. That particular play, both ends were crossing. Quarterback is looking, he's attempted 40 passes tonight.
That is a new Liberty Bowl record.
He'll break all kinds of records tonight. But I'm sure what he wants is the big W. Here's the bootleg, one-on-one pattern.
Tripped up from behind at the 46-yard line after picking up about 4 yards. Tom McCrary, the sophomore defensive tackle from Scottsboro, Alabama, making the tackle.
Here's the fake bootleg. Out to the wide side. He's looking for his crossing man. Big play by the young sophomore, Tom McCrary.
It'll be a third down and 8 call for Eason.
Double tight with one end standing up.
Eason's got a man open. Great grab. Brewster, first down at the 31-yard line. Tim Brewster, the tight end, a great grab, and he was stopped by Tommy Wilcox.
Just a fine reception. Good throw. You see the linebackers dropping into position. Brewster finds the alley. Almost a one-handed catch and more, and he holds on to the ball.
That is the end of the third quarter. With a timeout at the end of the third quarter, the score is Alabama 14, Illinois 6. We're looking back at Coach Bryant's illustrious career and his coaching days at Kentucky, and we'll be back after this. Illinois trails 14-6. This man is making himself known, etching his name in the record books here at the Liberty Bowl, Tony Eason.
He's broken Mark Herman's record, 289-yard net yardage. Mark Herman, Purdue, back in 1980.
And Eason already with 3-10. It is first and 10, Illinois at the 31-yard line. Fourth down just underway. Eason under pressure, gets away. Looks upfield. Now he's going to run forward and step out of bounds at the 27-yard line, a pickup of around 4. Pressure put on Eason, and he stepped out nicely and picked up a few yards.
He doesn't beat you with the run, but he does show the tremendous mobility that he does have to avoid the rush and then get on upfield.
Oh, Joe, the remarkable thing about Eason is after his junior college days, no one recruited him. He was recommended to Illinois' Mike White, that man, by a friend of Mike's out on the coast.
Now give Mike credit for recognizing talent.
It is second down and 7, Illinois.
Alabama in a 2-deep zone.
Pass up the middle inside the 20 to the 19-yard line.
This is what Tony Eason can do. Find the seams. He's got a great core of receivers to get open. Eason.
First catch by Miguel DeOliver, the senior from Sacramento, California.
This is bread and butter for Illinois.
Another first and 10. The Alabama 18-yard line. Illinois trails 14-6. A running play. Not too much there. Getting down to the 15-yard line is Riles. Richard Riles, the junior from San Jose, California, picked up 3 at 2nd and 7. Stopped by Mike Pitts.
Here you see the off tackle. He bounces it outside. Mr. Pitts, he's having a great football game.
He fought that block off very nicely.
Number 98 comes over to make sure. Jackie Klein.
And it's 2nd down and 7, Illinois.
14-6, an interesting score. Illinois scores here. They'll have an option to go for 2.
Eason. Up the middle, has his man DeOliver to the 1-yard line. Miguel DeOliver.
He found the crossing tight end.
Tight ends Brewster and DeOliver have been big for Illinois.
Right in between the linebackers. And he not only catches it, he stays tough and gets an additional 4 or 5 yards.
Rocky Colburn making the tackle. First down and goal, Illinois at the 1-yard line from the I formation. Mitchell Brookins, the tailback. He's their big money touchdown man. Not this time. Mitchell Brookins has scored 6 touchdowns rushing, 4 passing. Pass receiving, touchdown every 4.7 times he touched the ball during the regular season, but not that time. Might have lost a yard. Russ Wood there to make the hit for Alabama.
Illinois had a chance to beat Michigan this year. 4 shots inside the 10. Came up short.
Illinois now is short a man on the field, and Eason's going to have to call a timeout here pretty quickly or they're in trouble. He is going to call timeout because the 25-second clock was down to 8 seconds. And Eason knew they would lose 5 yards if he didn't quickly call time because they only had 10 men on the field. So Eason wisely uses a timeout rather than take the 5 yards, and he goes over to talk to his mentor, Mike White.
You know, 6 of the games that Illinois played of their 11 were decided on the last play. Quite a unique situation.
So an unbelievable stat.
They are very familiar with close football games.
6 of 11 games for the Fighting Illini decided on the last play of the game. Ordinarily, you might go through a season and have 1 like that. They've had 6.
Well, I think it's an example of the great game of college football. I think there's nothing as exciting as college football.
No question about that. And one of the great collegiate coaches, besides, of course, that man, Paul Bear Bryant, in his final coaching appearance, the all-time winningest coach in collegiate history. Another great coach received the Distinguished Service Award here at the Liberty Bowl this year. I speak of Eddie Robinson, the head football coach at Grambling, who has won 305 games in his brilliant coaching career. has sent more of his players to the pro ranks than any other school except USC, and a superb human being. And he will be chatting with us and analyzing this game with us shortly. 12:45 left to play. On a second down and goal call. Handoff, nothing there. Alabama's defense rearing up. And the ball is still on the 2-yard line. Illinois has enjoyed good fourth quarters. They need to put it in here, though, Joe Kay.
Well, I'm going to guess they're going to pass the football.
They have to. I don't think they can run her in.
Well, they've tried twice, and that Alabama defense is stout.
I look for an Eason rollout to the long side of the field.
Okay, coach.
Third down goal from the 2-yard line.
Little bit of indecision coming out of the huddle.
Eason straight back, lofts one for Williams. Out of his reach, it is incomplete, and it's decision time for Mike White. Ball still at the 2-yard line. You're gonna try for the 3, you're gonna go for the 6. 11:57 left.
14-6, 8 points.
Mike is going to try for the 6.
Play to win.
Fourth down and goal at the 2-yard line. The Oliver comes out. Coming in, Mike Martin.
He's got an interesting formation. Flood to the left.
Rolling out, he throws. It is a touchdown, Illinois. Caught by Oliver Williams. So on fourth down, Illinois is in the end zone, and it's 14-12 as Oliver Williams makes the reception. Now will Mike White go for 2 or for 1?
It's the sprint out to the wide side. You call it, Harry, one play later. Puts it on the money. It might be questionable whether he's in, except no question the official calls it.
I think he was in.
That was Williams' 6th catch, 74 yards on the day. Clutch throw, clutch catch. And I'm sure that coach right there is a happy man.
And he's going to go for the 2-point conversion.
That makes sense.
Line up on the far hash mark and roll right. Eason lofts it, and it is deflected and knocked down and incomplete. The 2-point conversion batted away. By guess who? Jeremiah Castile.
Just a great football player.
Here's the touchdown again.
Oh, yes. Easily in. Easily.
And with the score, Alabama 14, Illinois 12. We'll be back after this.
Tuesday, ESPN has the key to sorting out the ins and outs of professional basketball. It's This Week in the NBA with Greg Gumbel.
Back at the 24th annual Liberty Bowl, where it's tightened now. Alabama leading by 2, 11:53 left. Chris White is going to kick off. The coach's son, a freshman from Champaign. Normally it's Mike Bass, but Chris White now will be kicking off for Illinois. Eddie Robinson, Distinguished Service Award winner at this 24th annual Liberty Bowl, in the booth with us. The head coach at Grambling, 305 victories. Coach, good to see you. It's quite a game today.
It's real nice being here, and I think we're seeing a great game, great quarterbacking, great defensive play. It's a lot of hitting going on.
This is Joey Jones with the football for Alabama, coming to the near side. And gets up to the 35-yard line. A good return by Joey Jones. Eddie Robinson, we're also seeing, as you said, a lot of hitting. I'm very impressed with that defensive corner for Alabama, Jeremiah Castile.
Well, I think he's had about 3 interceptions, and they couldn't have come at a better time because Illinois seemed as if they were going in, and each time he turned them around.
Eddie, you certainly deserve this Distinguished Service Award, and as we mentioned, you've taken a lot of your college football players and led them to the pros. You've had a ton of them in the pros, have you not?
Well, yes, we've been real fortunate to have those good people play for us.
Lewis looks to put it up. Lewis in trouble. Dropped for a loss back at the 32-yard line. Alder Lewis, the quarterback, brought down by Don Thorpe. Illinois scoring drive. 13 plays, 68 yards, capped on a fourth down pass from Eason to Oliver Williams. What do you think of Eason?
Oh, I think he's an outstanding quarterback. He has really shown himself here tonight, and I think everybody will know about him and will expect great things out of him in the future.
Running room up the middle for Alabama's Ricky Moore, the 235-pound fullback, and he gains a lot of that lost yardage back. Brought down on the play by Clint Haynes, but not before he moved the ball to the 43-yard line, where it's third down and two. Coach Paul Bear Bryant, his final game as a head football coach. And Eddie, you have to have an awful lot of empathy for that man.
Well, you certainly have to. We see here tonight an ending of an era in football, and we all very emotional about it.
Third down, two, call. First down as he hurtled over the pile. Craig Turner, the ball carrier, moved the ball to the 45, and it'll be a first down, Alabama.
Coach Robinson, Coach Bryant has 322 wins, which surpasses Amos Alonzo Stagg, 314, and Glenn Pop Warner, 313. And next on the list is you, Coach, with 305. How many more years are you going to coach?
Well, I don't know. I said from 1 to 5, and Coach Bryant told me never to make that public statement like that. So I'm going to hang in there as long as I possibly can.
And I happen to personally know some of your great players. I'm a great admirer of Doug Williams, Willie Brown, great, great athletes and great human beings.
They really are. You know, Joe, something happened last night in the acceptance of this Distinguished Service Award, and Coach Bryant made the Stag. And then last night I was really honored to have the man who broke the Lonzo Stagg record present the trophy to us.
And your speech, I must say, Eddie, was very moving.
Lenny Patrick just picked up a first down for Alabama. Inside running play, and Alabama's offensive line now really making themselves felt. They're opening gaping holes for the Tide running backs. That one was run by Joe Carter, the junior from Starkville, Mississippi.
Coach, one great mark of a great football team is an offensive line that gets off, and that's what we're seeing here with Alabama right now.
Well, we certainly have. We've seen that all night. But, you know, I think both teams have been real good offensively and defensively.
It's a very well-played football game.
Second down and 5, Alabama. Walter Lewis going to put it up. Sideline pattern. He has his man for a first down, and that's wide receiver Joey Jones.
You know what I like about what Walter Lewis did there, and I think there's a good chance that he audible to play. Illinois was in an 8-man front. They were going to come in. They're ready to stop the run. I believe Lewis audibled and called the quick out pattern, and that's good quarterbacking.
Well, it certainly is, and this is what he'll have to do when they present the 8-man front.
That's right.
Ball at the 27-yard line.
I've got him softened up a little bit now. Now
first
he can run.
And 10. On the option play, Lewis keeps inside the 20 to the 19-yard line.
What I thought is that was a turning point in the first quarter when Alabama decided to go with the pass a while to not be predictable, and they were able to get in and score.
And that's what I love about the wishbone. If you have that great athlete and quarterback that can run and pass. And Walter Lewis can certainly do that. He's got 60 yards now and 9 carries.
Second down and 2, Alabama. They have the ball at the 18-yard line. Lewis keeps, pitches back. First down inside the 15 on the option play. So Alabama, after the Illinois touchdown, moving it briskly downfield.
Here he is.
Well executed.
You know, we ran that play back at the University of California in 1958 season, took us to the Rose Bowl, and our coach for that game was Pete Elliott, who later went to Illinois and coached a Rose Bowl team.
Oh, yes, I know Pete well.
First and 10, Illinois.
I had
Illinois.
A visit with him last Saturday in Chicago.
They have it at the 11-yard line, or rather Alabama at the Illinois 11-yard line, and Alabama gets two on the inside running play. It'll be second down and eight.
In fact, Coach Mike White got his coaching start on Pete Elliott's staff back at the University of California.
Ricky Moore, the ball carrier. It is second down and eight. Eddie Robinson, congratulations on your award, the Distinguished Service Award. Thanks a lot for being with us, and very best of luck to you.
It's real nice being here, and I certainly would like to express our appreciation to the people in Memphis and the Liberty Bowl Committee for the fine hospitality we've received here.
Second down and eight for Alabama. They have it at the Illinois 9-yard line. On the option play, Lewis pitches back, and inside the 5-yard line to about the 3-yard line goes Joe Carter.
And there you see some hard running. Illinois pursuit coming up.
Ball spotted at the 3. Carter getting it down to the 3-yard line, where it'll be third down and 2 for a first down, 3 for a touchdown.
A lot of substitutions now, both teams.
Alabama leading 14-12. We have 7:52 left to play.
They
Walter
dug
Lewis
in.
Brings them out.
That's a 9-man front.
Walter Lewis didn't like the 9-man front, and he called a timeout.
I'm not sure it's a call timeout. I think maybe because of the noise down in the end zone.
Well, that's probably so.
Quarterback has the right to ask the official to quiet down the fans. You'll see the heavy hitting on some of those hats. The scraped paint.
With 7:52 Timex time left here in the fourth and final period, the ball is on the Illinois 3-yard line, where it's third down and 2 for a first down, 3 for a touchdown for Alabama. Ricky Moore has carried 10 times for Alabama for 62 yards. Carter, who just moved the ball to the 3, 3 times for 19 yards. Bama by 2. Threatening to make it more.
This is where a team has to have concentration and discipline. Know the count. Great surge.
Lewis hands off just short of the touchdown goes Craig Turner.
Great offensive surge by the right side of the Alabama line.
That's Kayevec and Sism again. It's enough for a first down, so they have it first and goal at the 1/2-yard line. Didn't get in for the touchdown, but got the first down. And they have 4 shots from a 1/2 yard out.
I like the way Walter Lewis is in control of his offensive huddle.
Turner, touchdown Alabama. Craig Turner. Well, Alabama takes a 20-12 lead. On a good drive after an Illinois touchdown pass, Alabama moving it all the way downfield. Primarily on the ground.
Here you see the surge. Offensive has one advantage. They know the snap count. They come off the ball together. Craig Turner, who leads Alabama with 12 touchdowns on the season.
Peter Kim will attempt the conversion.
The Honolulu hitman.
Yeah, transfer from the University of Hawaii. He watched Alabama on television, liked their style, and went to Bama. And he is true with it. 7:34 left to play with the score. Alabama 21, Illinois 12. We'll be back after this. The 1983 Metro sports season will bring basketball fans the excitement of the best in major college basketball. With these conference packages, starting off the new year, will be the fast-paced action of the Big Ten. Competitiveness of great independent basketball featuring DePaul, Marquette, and Notre Dame, plus the hard-battling teams of the Big Eight. Check your local listing for all of these outstanding Metro Sports basketball matchups. Terry Sanders kicking off for Alabama. And again, it's a very short kickoff. This is Beverly at the 22. Beverly has some running room.
He's Beverly!
all the way to the 44 of Alabama. Beverly set up the last Illinois touchdown with a great return, and another one there by Dwight Beverly. Rocky Colburn, the touchdown saving tackle for Alabama.
Here we see from the ground, Beverly, a lot of running room, almost makes a great cut, almost has a shot to go all the way. Who makes the tackle?
Rocky Colburn, first and 10 at the 44-yard line. Eason going for the bundle. He's got a man, Martin. Martin to the 20, down to the 15, to the 12-yard line goes Mike Martin. Illinois can strike oh so quickly, Joe.
Yes, they can. And I know Coach Bryant would like to relax. No way. Fine throw, fine catch, and more than that, he hangs on to the football and gets on upfield.
Got away from the tackle by Colburn. It's first down.
But once again, Alabama, I mean, that could have gone for a touchdown. Alabama recovers and gets up to prevent the touchdown. Coach Bryant cannot relax as yet.
First down at the 12-yard line. Eason throwing toward the end zone, incomplete. Illinois' history this year, although they have such a potent offense, has been that they move the ball so well from 20 to 20, but inside that 20, they have a tough time.
A lot of pressure from the outside, one-on-one coverage out here. Jeremiah Castile.
We've said his name a few times tonight.
It is second down and 10 for Illinois at the Alabama 12-yard line.
What a football game.
Tony Eason.
They're in a zone.
Looks upfield, throws up the middle to his tight end. It's short of the first down, but he gets it to the 5-yard line, does Tim Brewster.
Alabama mixing up their man-to-man coverage, which we were on the play previous. Here they're dropping into a two-deep zone. Eason reading it and hitting his short man. Brewster, the tight end.
Ball spotted at the 6, so it's a third down and 4 call for Illinois.
Both teams playing with great confidence.
Tony Eason has shattered Liberty Bowl records with his arm. Throwing to the end zone, way overthrown. His intended receiver was Oliver Williams.
Once again, Alabama mixing up the zone and man-to-man coverage. Illinois had him in the right defense.
Well, we hope you've enjoyed throughout tonight's telecast our scenes of America. Liberty Bowl synonymous with America. Metro Sports has shown you these here in the 24th annual Liberty Bowl Classic. And now they are going to go for the field goal on fourth down. Mike Bass under the hold of Tim Damron.
It would appear thusly. They may do the fake.
No fake. Bass's boot certainly long enough, and it is good by Mike Bass. 6:12 left to play as Illinois tacks on 3. And with the score, Alabama 21, Illinois 15. We'll be back after this. Well, at this time, we'd like to thank the staffs of these two fine universities for their assistance with tonight's telecast. The University of Alabama Athletic Director and Head Football Coach Paul Bear Bryant. Sports Information Director Larry White, along with Jack Perry. For the University of Illinois Athletic Director Neil Stoner, Head Football Coach Mike White, Sports Information Director Tab Bennett, and of course for the Liberty Bowl Classic, Bud Dudley, Executive Director of the Liberty Bowl. And our thanks too to our statistician Gary Lynn, who's done a great job for us tonight, and spotter Billy Grace. Chris White kicking off for Illinois. Taken by Joey Jones. Joey Jones over the 20 to about the 24 before he is stacked up, and Alabama will have it first and 10 at their own 24-yard line. With 6:06 left, Paul Bryant would like to see that clock wind down. He has a 6-point lead.
Oh, I think we're going to see a lot of offense still today. Lewis is now 7 of 11, 129 yards in the air. Rushed 8 times for 59 yards.
Let's go down to Johnny Holiday.
Well, about this time of the game, you start to speculate about the most viable player. Of course, Alabama's head coach, Paul Bear Bryant, would probably say the entire team should get the award. How about Jeremiah Castile for his outstanding job tonight? Three interceptions.
That would be my vote, Johnny. On the option play, Lewis keeps, gets a first down before he's driven out of bounds. Walter Lewis also certainly should be considered for his fine leadership of the Crimson Tide, as should Tony Eason.
But I think we ought to wait till the end of the game.
I think we will wait toward the end of the game. There is a penalty on the play against Alabama. It's going to nullify that first down run by Walter Lewis.
There's an Illinois player down on the sideline.
That is Mark Butkus, 6'4", 260-pound junior from Lansing, Illinois. Nephew of Illinois' great linebacker, Dick Butkus. Illinois has had a history of some pretty good linebackers. Butkus, Ray Nitschke.
Some great football players. Bill Brown, Red Grange, Abe Woodson,
J.C.
Bobby Mitchell,
Caroline.
Some all-timers.
Ball at the 19-yard line where it's first down and 15. Side handoff, picking up about 4 yards on the play, was Ricky Moore, brought down by Pete Mulcro. So it is now a second down and 10 for Alabama.
6 points separates the two teams.
Get him, get him.
Inside handoff again to Ricky Moore. Not much there. He got a couple of yards, and that's about all. It'll be a third down and 8. Getting up off the bottom of the pile for Illinois, Dan Gregus, the senior from Hickory Hills, Illinois.
Well, we've seen how potent the Illinois offense is, so.
Darrell White comes in at a wide receiver spot for Alabama on a third down and 8 call.
So the importance of this third down situation is, what can you say?
They want to keep
eight
their hands.
Eight man front, man-to-man coverage.
Lewis gets away from the rush, but he is going to be stopped short of a first down. There is a fumble, and Illinois has recovered. 91, Terry Cole pounces on that football. Illinois will be in business at the Alabama 24-yard line, first and 10.
Here's the sprint out pattern. A lot of pressure. Lewis gets upfield.
Boy, that's a great effort by number 96 on the tackle, Don Thorpe, and the ball was recovered by Terry Cole. What an effort by Don Thorpe, who made that play from Arlington Heights, Illinois.
Walter did not put the ball away. He did not tuck it in.
Ball at the 24-yard line. 4 minutes and 38 seconds left in the game and the coaching career of Bear Bryant.
And for the first time, Illinois gets in an I formation, a quick screen pass out to the left.
And Beverly fights his way inside the 20 to about the 19-yard line. Beverly, who has been brilliant at kickoff returns, catching that pass.
Here we see cutting back against the grain, getting a lot out of the play. About a 5-yard gain.
Tom McCrary making the tackle for Alabama. It's second down and 5. Illinois at the Alabama 19-yard line.
And for the second time tonight, they line up in an I formation. And again, they fake the good screen to the right, screen to the left. And
good, sure tackle on the play. It was complete to Murphy, and Tommy Wilcox made the sure tackle.
Once again, as we said before, 6 of the 11 games that Illinois played in this season were decided on the final play.
That is incredible. This might be another one. 3:32 left. Third down and about 3 for Illinois. Alabama leading 21-15. Eason. Eason's going to be in trouble, and he is sacked back at the 22-yard line by the blitzing Tommy Wilcox from his safety spot.
Here we see it from ground level. Eason takes a look.
credit the secondary. Can't find anybody open.
There's Wilcox, 15, and also 94, Tom McCrary, the sophomore, who's had a big game for Alabama. Timeout is called. Eason is back down on the field.
He took a very heavy hit. Both times that he's been down, he seems to hold his chest. He could be playing with sore ribs. It's hard to play an 11-man season without sore ribs when you play quarterback.
With our score, 21-15, Alabama leading Illinois. We'll be back after this. Illinois after the fumble recovery. Here's the sack of Eason. Scrambled out of the grasp of one, but not out of Tom McCrary, the sophomore from Scottsboro, Alabama. And Eason is going off the field.
There's his statistics. 32 for 51, 373 yards. Wow.
Four interceptions and one touchdown.
And he's hurting. I don't know if it's his ribs or his shoulder. Well, that's tough to have to leave the game in this situation.
It is a fourth down situation at the Alabama 22-yard line. Chris Jenner, the junior, coming in at quarterback, only threw three passes during the regular season, has thrown one tonight. It was intercepted.
Split backs. Looks like a zone defense. They're going to play it safe. And he looks like he changes the play to the double tight.
Nearly delay a gain. They had only 1 second. He gets the pass away. It is picked off by Alabama. Back to the 25. This is Lowe. And Lowe is finally dropped at the 33-yard line. Eddie Lowe, the senior from Phenix City, Alabama.
The captain of the defensive unit, great football player.
You know, the remarkable thing about Eddie Lowe, his brother Woodrow, an All-American at Alabama, as we look at it again.
Watch his drop. He's back in great position. Jenner really shouldn't have thrown the ball.
Eddie Lowe was pretty good. He was not recruited by Alabama. He went to the University of Tennessee, Chattanooga, and then finally talked his way on to Alabama, transferred, and he's been their leading tackle. Well, big play there for him.
Pretty good move for an inside linebacker.
First and 10, Alabama at the 32-yard line, 2:54 left to play. Lewis going to throw the ball, short. Surprising.
Taking what the defense is giving. Illinois up in a eight-man front. Single coverage on the wideout.
Second down and 10. 2 minutes, 50 seconds left to go in the 24th annual Liberty Bowl. 2 minutes, 50 seconds left to go in the coaching career of a legend. There is Tony Eason. And you could read his lips. He said, I'm all right. He wants back in there if Illinois gets the ball back.
Here's a new formation. Double wing, give to the running back.
Ricky Moore, the big 235-pound fullback. Moore picked up on the play around four or five. It'll be third down. 2 minutes and 34 seconds left in this man's career. Going for number 323.
Ricky Moore's a hard man to bring down.
Third down, six for Alabama. They have it at their own 36.
There's eight men up.
On the option play, pitch back, short of a first down. The ball at the 40-yard line, shy of the first down. Ball carrier was Joe Carter, and he was stopped short of a first down at his fourth down. Brought down on the play by Mark Jones on a first down saving tackle. Jones was shaken up on the play, the senior from Lancaster, California. Alabama brings their punter in, Malcolm Simmons from Montgomery. Going back in safety for Illinois will be their wide receiver, Mike Martin.
Well,
Illinois will get the ball back with a minute 45 left to play. Alabama leading 21-15. There's the man that made the first down saving tackle Mark Jones being helped off the field.
Very hard hitting football game. And a complete new defensive unit for Illinois.
The punt return team and the man in solo safety is Mike Martin. They got the punt of Malcolm Simmons. Martin standing back at his 25-yard line. Alabama by six, 1:45 left to play.
He's the all-time record holder at Alabama.
Yards per punt in the season, 43.3 this year he averaged.
Illinois have their 10-man front. They have a return on.
Martin calls the fair catch at the 19-yard line. Illinois 81 yards away. And they will take over first and 10 with a minute 43 left to play. And let's see if that man, Tony Eason, is coming back. He is. Eason, who has shattered the Liberty Bowl records for passes attempted, passes completed, and yardage. The yardage mark held by Purdue's great Mark Herman. Eason's coming back.
And the Illinois crowd, sensing that Eason is the man, giving him a big cheer as he returns to the football game.
There's our Liberty Bowl most valuable player, Jeremiah Castile. Three interceptions, forced a fumble on a hard hit at the 2-yard line. Our Holiday Inn MVP. Got a man. It's caught at the 42-yard line. A great catch and hold by Joe Curtis, the senior from Chicago.
This was a sprint out to the left with a throwback to the backside. Well-designed play against the zone. And once again, he pays.
He paid on a hit by Rocky Colburn, but he held on. First and 10, Illinois at the 42-yard line, their own 42. Eason throws a pass, and he's got Martin. Martin in Alabama territory at the Alabama 45-yard line. Eddie Lowe and Tommy Wilcox the tackle. 1:20 left to play.
And he threw a bullet. That ball was right on the money. Laces up.
Illinois trailing by six. 1:20 left in the Liberty Bowl. Illinois, six of their last of their regular season 11 games decided on the last play. This might be another one.
Alabama in the zone the last two times out. Safety blitz, safety blitz.
Eason gets away from it and runs out of bounds at the 40-yard line, picked up around 5 yards. So Eason, showing good mobility, got away from the blitz.
The strong safety did not keep outside leverage. He allowed Eason to get outside of him.
It was Tommy Wilcox, so it'll be second down and 5. The ball at the 40-yard line of Alabama.
Another Liberty Bowl record, Mike Martin. 125 yards.
Led the nation in receptions this year, did Martin, number 4, with 69 of them. Second down, 5, Illinois.
Sprint out to the wide side.
Eason. Pass is caught. A great catch at the 30-yard line by Oliver Williams.
Had the right play on against the defense. Down and out. When in doubt.
Stan Gay defending for Alabama, but a fine reception by Oliver Williams. Looked it right into his...
Good coverage. Defensive corner has to give him some room.
First and 10, Illinois at the Alabama 30-yard line. Illinois down by six. 45 seconds left to play.
Here
look out.
The blitz.
Goodbye at the 41. Russ Wood, number 89 from Elba, Alabama, a sack. Eason never saw him coming. Blind side, and Eason is down again. What a courageous young man Tony Eason is.
He took a very, very hard hit. Here he comes.
Boom.
You think he was thinking extra special?
Russ Wood, the senior from Elba, Alabama, the sack.
You think Russ had the coach on his mind?
Yep, well, that one might have been for the Bears.
And he was putting that 100% effort.
35 seconds remaining in this man's coaching career. Eason on his feet, wobbly, walking toward the sideline. Wow, what a courageous performance by Tony Eason tonight. And again, Chris Jenner is going to come in at quarterback on a second down.
Well, Chris is 2 for 2 now.
And long.
Alabama's 3-deep zone, safety up.
Jenner throws it right into the arms of the defender. That's Robbie Jones, and Jones has sewed it up for Alabama. 16 seconds on the clock, and Paul Bear Bryant's legendary coaching career is going to end with another W, his 323rd.
Well, it would appear that way. Coach, there's 16 seconds left to go in the game.
I understand that.
We want every high school football player to know the game is not over until it's over.
21-15, Alabama. Alabama will have the football. They'll just fall on it and kill the clock here.
Stranger things have happened.
Walter Lewis. No, that's not Walter Lewis. That is Paul Fields, the junior, falling on the ball. Illinois stops the clock with 11 seconds left. Paul Fields, number one, is the quarterback.
What a football game this has been.
Really has been. You have to admire the courage of Tony Eason, who has shattered Liberty Bowl records. The leadership of Walter Lewis for Alabama. The defensive brilliance, our Holiday Inn most valuable player, Jeremiah Castillo.
I think Ken Donahue, the defensive coordinator for Alabama, has done a magnificent job. He mixed the zone coverage, the 2-deep zone, 3-deep zone. He brought safeties. He brought linebackers. He caused problems for the great Illinois passing attack all game long.
Ball at the 44-yard line, just 11 ticks left on the clock. Paul Fields, who is the holder, sure-handed. That's why he's in there, just to fall on the football. And before the snap was made, Illinois jumped offside, so Illinois will be penalized. And the legend going to win his final game and go 300.
There he is.
23.
The coach's coach.
Yep. He'll go 323, 85, and 17. In his career. That was a procedure penalty against Alabama. Moved it back to the 39. But with just 11 seconds left, Paul Fields will merely flop on the football. 21-15, Alabama. Fields just falls on it. Illinois calling timeout, stopping the clock with 7 seconds left. That, I believe, is their final timeout.
Paul Bryant probably affected the game of football more than any man in the history. I think he's turned out something like you mentioned it earlier, 45 coaches into the profession of...
Remarkable man. Paul Bear Bryant. This is the last game in his...
He was asked the other day, what would he be doing when spring practice rolls around next year, and he said, well, he'd probably be on some bank somewhere fishing while somebody else is out there sweating and stinking.
He's had 6 national championships. 8 of his teams went undefeated in the regular season.
29 bowl games. Coming into this one. It's all winding down now. Illinois making contact. That'll be against Illinois.
This is a hard-fought victory. Illinois
really
played
was.
A fine football game.
He certainly did. 21-15, Alabama. Paul Fields will just drop on it for the final time.
Got that right. That's right.
Thanks for the memories.
Sound like Bob Hope.
4-3-2-1. The 24th annual Liberty Bowl is history. Paul Bear Bryant goes out a winner in his final game. 21-15, Alabama.
The winningest coach of all time. Collegiate. Amos Alonzo Stagg, Pop Warner, Eddie Robinson.
On the shoulders of his team. Boy, what a man. Bear Bryant. Think of the lives that he has affected. All of the young men that have gone through the program at Alabama and how much Paul Bear Bryant has meant to them, their careers, their lives. Mike White, an admirable job. That's the end of the game with a score, Alabama 21, Illinois 15. We'll be back with our final comments after this. Page in the book of a legend has been transcribed. All that is left to say is thanks, Bear. 21-15, Alabama over Illinois. The executive producer of the 1982 Liberty Bowl is Leonard Klompas. The coordinating producer has been Dalia Witkowski Productions. Tonight's game has been produced by Paul Carlson, directed by Marcia Cherner. Directed by David DeMatt, Associate producer is Marcia Cherner. Production assistant, Skip Desjardins. Broadcast services arranged by Stephen Daniel Poor. Commercial operations arranged by Allison Band. Production facilities supplied by Unitel Productions in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, and Cruise Unlimited in Crestwood, Kentucky.
Paul Bear Bryant, unquestionably one of the most dominant figures in the history of college football, nestled into his usual pregame perch underneath the goalpost as he surveyed his team. At last night's Liberty Bowl, the Bear said goodbye to the game he loved so much. Along with him, a capacity crowd packed the stands in Memphis, Tennessee, all wanting to witness history in the making. Some have called Bear Bryant cranky, unbending. Some even called him a tyrant, if that's what it took to win. Well, he did a lot of that. With 6 national championships and 14 SEC titles under his belt, he prowled the sidelines for 38 seasons. They were glorious years for Bear Bryant, but as all good things must come to an end, so too must a glorious coaching career in college football. The opponent for his final game was the Fighting Illini of Illinois. And for a while, it looked as though they might cause some problems for the old Bear. But the tide rose to the occasion when Randy Edwards blocked a Mike Bass field goal in the first quarter. On the very next play, Alabama quarterback Walter Lewis hit Joey Jones on a 50-yard pass play to put them on the Illinois 26. Three plays later, fullback Ricky Moore burst over right tackle, and it looked like the Bear could be on his way to a victory in his 29th bowl appearance. But in the second quarter, following a tied interception, Illinois scored on this two-yard dive by Joe Curtis. The extra point was no good. In the third quarter, Alabama moved 50 yards in 10 plays. The final 3 yards coming on this Jesse Bendros end around to make it 14-6 tied. Illinois quarterback Tony Eason was shaken up on the ensuing series, and when his replacement Chris Jenner tried to take the team in for a score, Liberty Bowl MVP Jeremiah Castile picked up his third interception of the day. After Alabama had problems offensively, Eason re-entered the game and passed to Oliver Williams to make the score 14-12. The Crimson Tide then proceeded to march down the field, and Greg Turner dived into the end zone to make the score 21-12 Bama. Illinois would add a field goal to make it 21-15 final. Bear Bryant would close out his coaching career.
The 4 years I've known him and been a part of him, and he's been like a father. He's been like a person, a close friend, and I love him to death, and just God bless him, and I hope he has many good years ahead of him.
That admiration is one of the rewards of years of service to the game. Starting way back in 1930, a young Paul Bryant starred at Fordyce High School in Arkansas. Later, his talents helped take him to the University of Alabama, to the 1934 Rose Bowl. Bitten by the bug, his first head coaching job at Maryland lasted just 1 year. Then in 1950, he took the Kentucky Wildcats to the only SEC title the school ever had. When Texas A&M beckoned, he took up the challenge to guide the Aggies, but the lure of his alma mater was just too strong, and in 1958, Paul Bear Bryant began his 24-year stint as head coach of the Crimson Tide. By 1981, a record-breaking 315 wins put him in a league all his own. A year later, his successor remembers the man.
I know that he instilled in me a need for discipline from an individual standpoint and team concept standpoint. Also, he instilled in me early in my career, when I was a freshman and sophomore, the necessity to really make some sort of a commitment one way or the other on something and set your goals high and then discipline yourself to do it.
Last night's final farewell was befitting a king. As the Bear stalked the sidelines for the last time, his decision to step aside became crystal clear.
When it dawned on me, and it did, that I wasn't doing a good job, that they should have someone better. That, Alabama was my school, and I want to do better. And last year, we lost a couple of games we should have won easily. And this year, we only played five, what I would call, satisfactory games, but real tough games, a couple of great ones, and lost one of those. And I thought we had personnel to do a lot better than that, and I think someone else can do a lot better than that.
And it was a difficult decision?
Well, no, it really wasn't. When I got thinking about it, I got thinking about it, heck, maybe I should have done it last year, after last season. Or maybe 4 or 5 years ago when we had a great year. But I've always said, and people said, I've had letters from people saying, you're not a quitter, you know, I'm not quitting. I've been saying for 10 years that as long as we won, I was going to keep on coaching, continue to coach. And we're not winning now, so I want somebody to come in and do some more winning.
What can the kids look forward to? Obviously, you're going to be the athletic director. Will you have any kind of input into the team?
No, none whatsoever. And actually, I have no desire to be athletic director. I want to be there and try to help any way I can until we get things settled. But I hopefully I'll be doing something else before the next football season, because the main thing I don't want to do is to be around and get in the way.
And so the Bear closed the book on his career of 38 years. They say he was a maker of men. Last night, that became quite clear when his men saw to it that he went out with dignity.